Greetings and salutations, ladies and gentlemen. Jeffery Wilson coming to you once again, live and direct, downtown Davenport, Iowa, at the River Center, as we about ready to kick off Caged Aggression 33, Trifecta Night Number 3. And I'm telling you what, it has been an absolute blast. Incredible fights last night. Congratulations to some of the winners last night. We had Jimmy Padilla taking on Brant Cooper. Jimmy Padilla picking up a very impressive second round victory over a tough Brant Cooper. And Mike Plazola against Sean the Exception West. Expected that one to stay on their hands, as these guys are really known for their striking. And Sean West picked up a very impressive first round submission. Joining me on the stick, calling the scraps, he is former UFC welterweight champion, Hall of Famer, trainer of champions, the Croatian sensation, Pat Miletich. Pat, how we doing tonight, champ?
I'm doing good. It's nice to be working. I get to, last night I got to sit back, watch the fights, as well as Thursday night, but tonight I'll get to work with you, so I'm excited.
Well, let's do it. And what are some of the fights that we're looking at, some of the people we're looking at tonight? We got Brandon Mills, who is the son of your friend and former student, Matt Hughes. Give us your thoughts on that.
Well, Brandon Mills, obviously training at American Top Team. You know, he's been making great improvements. I asked him specifically, what have you worked on leading into this fight? And he said his striking a lot because, you know, last time he got in a little bit of trouble here and there, got a little fatigued where he was having trouble having to get takedowns and getting outstruck a little bit in that last fight. So he definitely needed to improve in that area, which he says he has.
Speaking of striking, somebody I'm really looking forward to and want to get your thoughts on it, Thomas Blackerby. This kid is 19 years old, a Muay Thai striking just savant. He's been very busy since we last saw him. Give us your thoughts on Thomas.
Well, his father, Ryan Blackerby, I've known for many, many, many years, probably 25 years easy that I've known his father. Father, a very, very skilled mixed martial artist, as well as a Muay Thai coach. And I tell you, gosh, we were training together, two decades ago, easy. So Thomas has been raised in that atmosphere. Thomas's striking is ridiculous. And I asked Ryan, his father, I said, can you do anything with your son anymore, you know, as far as sparring or anything like that? And he said, maybe boxing, I might be able to get him a little bit, but not anymore. So Thomas is an extremely dangerous, dangerous fighter.
Very tough kid. Been in the game since potty training, as we're seeing here tonight. And our main event tonight, Gabriel Mota facing up against Cedric Savage. Give us your thoughts on that one.
Well, when I look at their records, their win-loss, how they lost, how they won, you know, Mota's a guy who almost every win has been by striking, every loss has been by submission. So that gives away the Achilles heel that he has, that Mota's has. So really it's going to come down. I think both guys really like to strike. So we'll see how that goes. We'll see if Savage goes for the takedown and goes for maybe the easier route, or he wants to stand up and make it a little more exciting for the crowd.
It is about to go down, ladies and gentlemen. The champ has spoken. So without any further ado, let's get on the good foot and do the bad thing, and let's kick off this final night of an incredible weekend of Caged Aggression 33. The trifecta, let's throw it up to our ring announcer, Jason, and let's make it happen.
Ladies and gentlemen, fight fans of all ages, this is the moment you've been waiting for as 7G Distributing Bud Light proudly presents Caged Aggression 33, the trifecta, our special mega three-night event hosted by the River Center. My name is Jason, your official voice from inside the camera cage, and it's my pleasure to welcome you back for night three of our special weekend. Over 70 fighters from 9 different states have come together here at the River Center for a historic, action-packed 3 nights of MMA. Our first 2 nights brought us exciting debuts, triumphant returns, back and forth battles, dramatic finishes, and new champions crowned. I'm excited to see what tonight brings as we close out Caged Aggression 33, the trifecta. Special thanks to all of our event partners that came together and made this entire weekend possible. The River Center, the official home of Caged Aggression MMA, 7G Distributing Bud Light, thank them often, but thank them responsibly. La Quinta Inns and Suites, Ducky's Formal Wear, Galesburg, The Dam View Inn, Mitt Beast Boxing and MMA, Yabba Dabba's House of Glass, Stand and Protect, Iowa Auto Club West, Elite Loyalty Management, Old Town Heating and Air, The Sneaker Vault, Squirrel's Tree Care, Delph's Pro Gym, The Cigar Social, Banker's Life, Kaylee Stout, and McCarl Family Racing, who urges you, if you're experiencing swollen lymph nodes, don't assume it's just an infection. It could be something much, much more serious. So get it checked out. It could save your life. Let's go ahead and give all of our event partners a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. It's Special thanks to our production team, Mindprint Productions, The Music Connection, and Say Uncle Photography. Much gratitude to all our fighters, coaches, and teams for their tireless commitment to be here this weekend. To you, the fans, of course, we wouldn't be here without any of you, and the Caged Aggression President's Mike Goodwin for continually raising the bar and inspiring greatness in all of us. Let's give all those people a round of applause. All of tonight's bouts have been sanctioned by the Iowa Athletic Commission. Deputy Ben Wilson, Inspectors George Chamberlain and Benji Williams, cage side tonight, our grease man, Kevin Night Night Anderson, our timekeeper, Clint, the antagonist Anderson, our judges, Alex Orozco, Ian Haas, and Matt White, our cage side physician tonight, Dr. Metcalf, our card girls for the evening, the lovely Serena, Dot, and Jessica, our pay-per-view commentary provided by Jason Bermas, Jeffery Wilson, and UFC Hall of Famer Pat Miletich. And when the action begins, our referees in charge, Josh Stewart, and the boss, Bruce Allen. Don't forget, you can have your very own piece of this historic event from this weekend by visiting our friends over at the QC Sneaker Vault for our special custom event t-shirts. That's courtesy of the Sneaker Vault and Old Town Heating and Air. Now, if you'll all please rise and help me welcome Miss Greater Des Moines 2022, Alyssa Gothy, for the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled
One more time, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Greater Des Moines 2022, Alyssa Gothy. All right, so anyone that saw nights one and night two, you all already know how high the bar has been set. So here we go, River Center. Night three coming up. Who's ready? Who's ready? All right, listen, I'm gonna need your all's help here. I need you guys to make some noise, stomp your feet, clap your hands, scream at the top of your lungs. We need to let everybody back in the locker room know you're ready. Let's let those fighters hear it. Come on.
Snap, sorry, hot mic. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Here we are, night three of Caged Aggression 33, the trifecta. Like our ring announcer just mentioned, the first couple nights, the bar has been set high. We've been seeing some incredible scraps, and here we are kicking off Corey Armstrong and Jake Bauer as Corey Armstrong makes his way to the Caged Aggression cage, fighting out of Extreme Combat Martial Arts, Peoria, Illinois. Wrestled in high school. Coach got him interested in the game, and here he is. He thinks it's a good matchup. Thinks his grappling skills with his wrestling and grappling will be a good matchup. Solid striking. Good wrestling, good ground game. Looks up to George St. Pierre. Fought at Harris Casino in New Orleans and has submitted a purple belt before. No shortage of confidence in Mr. Corey Armstrong. Again, shout out to all the participants who participated this weekend. Big ups to the winners last night in our co-main and main event. Jimmy Padilla with an incredible second-round submission over Brant Cooper. Very, very tough kid. And Mike Plazola and Sean West. Sean the Exception West with an incredible first-round submission.
In terms of your comment about Corey Armstrong submitting a purple belt, which everybody has done that before in the gym, but in terms of MMA, it should have been prefaced with punched him 747 times and then submitted him. That's what leads to a submission against good jiu-jitsu people.
Well, Mr. Miletich, you actually know a little bit about a submission in the main event of the evening last night. Kind of a ad hoc coach in the corner, and basically your guy brought him over and you walked him through a very quick armbar.
He did a great job. He walked the legs up, did exactly as he was told, spun, took the arm, and it was game over. So that was beautiful.
When it was interesting because our broadcast partner last night, Jordan the Henchman Hinman, showed me the clip and the video of him fighting Mike Plazola, and their fight ended almost literally identical the same way with a submission armbar with the same referee, Bruce Allen. As Jake Bauer makes his way to the cage, aggression cage, fighting out of Elite Edge MMA, Myriad Ames Jiu-Jitsu out of Ames, Iowa. Started with jiu-jitsu, got into striking a couple years later, and here he is in the cage aggression cage. He recognizes his matchup is both have the same record, should be a great matchup. Feels his strengths are his submission game, one of the best in his weight class, and his cardio and his heart will be the difference maker. Looks up to gentlemen like Brian Ortega, as well as the current UFC lightweight champion Charles Oliveira. Ran his own jiu-jitsu gym in Ames, and here he is tonight, getting ready to square off against Corey Armstrong as we kick off the first fight of our third night. Wow, it's been a long weekend, but I wouldn't be wanting to do anything else, brother. Calling the fights with my good buddy JB, Pat Miletich, Jordan Hinman, Lil Evil, Jens Pulver. It's been an incredible weekend.
Good company.
Good company indeed. We have our work cut out for us tonight. We got quite the bevy of matchups here. I'm looking forward to Mr. Brandon Mills. I'm looking forward to all of them, but Brandon Mills, the son of Matt Hughes, looking forward to Thomas Blackerby, someone I've become a huge fan of. That kid has mad game. And of course, looking forward to our co-main and main event, Nico Jefferson against Michael Battleship, as well as our main event, Gabriel Mota against Cedric Savage. But don't want to get ahead of ourselves. We got to go through all these matchups first before we get to those, and looking forward to this as we kick it off. How are polls looking, JB?
We got Jake Bauer coming in at 57% and change as the favorite, and Corey Armstrong as the underdog at 44%.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Lightweight Division, powered by Delft's Pro Gym. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'8" tall and weighed in at 155 pounds. He trains with Extreme Combat Martial Arts. Joining us from Bartonville, Illinois, Corey Armstrong. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'11" tall and weighed in at 160 pounds. He trains with Elite Edge MMA and Myriad American Jiu-Jitsu. He's sponsored by Jenk and Jose Ames Area Movers, Lincoln Way Energy, and Octopus Films. Joining us from Ames, Iowa, Jake Bauer.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Touching up the center of the cage.
Good leg kicks already from Bauer. And I like that there's another leg kick, keeping it at a distance, not committing too much, feint, good body kick.
Corey's got his hands pretty low, need to raise them up a little bit.
Armstrong already looks pretty uncomfortable in there. Bauer landing those leg kicks at will.
Finding a home with them bad boys, it'll slow you down in a heartbeat.
He's going to get head kicked.
Those hands are low, you are.
He's chasing kicks with his legs, or with his arms, he's gonna get head kicked.
And I don't think that Pat is Nostradamus, but he's seen a lot of head kicks in his day, and he's seen a lot of setups. I wouldn't doubt the man. Don't blink. We could be seeing that as close to the next 90 seconds.
Oh, wow. There it is. He's finding his sweet spot.
He's really uncomfortable in there. He needs to get those hands up.
Well, again, he's still chasing after getting kicked in the chops. Luckily, he didn't take a shin bone all the way through. It'd already be over, so Ooh, there's another one. Just a love tap.
Ooh, right hand comes across from Bauer. Bauer dominating this fight. Ooh,
oh,
there's
wow.
the head kick right there.
That's going to, yeah.
Ooh, that rocked him.
He's
his
lipping,
leg's uncomfortable.
He's lipping.
Those leg kicks are finding a home, and it's just a matter of time, I believe, before one of them, one of those kicks lands right on the chin.
This is a walking highlight reel.
Armstrong just looks, his disposition, he looks uncomfortable.
Well, he hasn't been taught defense very well, and that's something that, you know, is the most important ultimately.
Oh, Jake Bauer again, and he's just having fun in there at this point.
Clock is ticking, I believe.
This is
That's it. We're calling
it's
it.
Over.
That's it. He called it. He did the right thing, and you know what? The ref got in there really, really quickly. Right thing to do. Jake Bauer looked focused from the very beginning. Implemented his game plan. You know, I'd like to see him against a little higher level of a striker. Probably a fun fight to watch.
Yeah.
Corey just looked like he didn't want to be there. Kudos to him. He did step into the cage, but yeah, tonight was not his night. Jake Bauer, he kicked this off with a first round knockout.
Good shit, brother. Good shit.
Yeah, no stop, not no stop. Can't call that out.
How long it's going to go, really, unless they've got an iron chin and they can take massive amounts of abuse. But he just hasn't been taught footwork and head movement and defense. And that's always first. If you go somewhere to learn how to defend yourself and they teach you offense first, then you go somewhere else.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute 44 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by knockout, Jake Bauer. All right, come on over, Jake. Hey, way to come out, set the tempo for night three with a big win, man. Talk to us how it feels coming out and making a statement like that.
Thank you, sir. Very appreciative of Mike to have me on this card tonight. I just want to give a big thank you to all my teammates at Elite Edge MMA, Marriott Ames American Jiu-Jitsu, all my teammates, all the guys at Henzo Gracie Des Moines. I appreciate every single one of you guys for pushing me every single day. And we're moving on to the next one. You guys didn't get to see my jiu-jitsu tonight, but I have one of the best jiu-jitsu games at my weight class in the Midwest. And maybe next time you guys will get to see it. But my striking is on the rise.
I'm glad you brought that up. It's nothing official yet. We got to check on it. I think you've landed the most kicks in a minute in the first round in caged aggression history. We'd have to look into that. But what was the plan coming in tonight, Jake?
The plan was put the pressure on him. You know, my striking's been getting much better. I wanted to come out here tonight and show everybody that I'm not just a jiu-jitsu guy. I'm a well-rounded fighter. And the plan was to put the pressure on him and just let him crumble. And we were able to do it, so.
Well, I think you made that statement quite well. Anything else you want to add to this?
Yo, I want to say thank you to my family that's here tonight. Thank you guys for always coming out to my fights and supporting me. To all the, my family and friends that support me, thank you guys. And I appreciate all you guys.
Looking forward to the next time, Jake. Until then, let's hear it one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner, Jake Bauer.
Oh, Bud Light Seltzer Retro Tata.
Have you tried these yet?
I'm sorry, ladies. It's my roommate, Emmerich.
Emmerich. Is that Irish?
Bud Light Seltzer Retro Tata, the loudest flavors ever.
Oh, he's got my attention right there, coming out a little Rage Against the Machine. Shout out and congratulations to Jake Bauer on a very quick and short work KO in the first round. As we move on to fight number two, Anthony Lloyd and Josh Richardson. Anthony Lloyd making his way to the cage aggression cage out of Marty's Martial Arts, Rock Island, Illinois. Got into MMA from watching Bruce Lee as a kid. I'm sure that's a pretty common story. He's going to be competitive. He feels that his opponent has a lot of experience, feels that his striking and his cardio should be better this time, and feels that that will be the difference maker. Looks up to Izzy Israel Adesanya. Not a bad one to be looking up to. How's the poll looking on this one, JB?
We got Anthony Lloyd coming in at the favorite, 62.5%, and Josh Richardson at 37.5%. Gotta love this song. And I like the t-shirts that came out. It just says MMA, pretty basic. That's what they're here to do tonight.
This stands for Marty's Martial Arts.
You know what? I didn't get the pun. I'm a little slow.
That's unlike you.
Right?
Let's not.
Two nights in a row, I've beat you up. Huh?
Yeah, exactly. Everybody.
It happens.
Oh, good times. I don't think the next song can be as good, but we'll see. You know, maybe we're going to get a happier song, a more fun song. But he's looking focused in there.
We have had some killer walkout songs this weekend. Unfortunately, I cannot in any way, shape, or form stand by our broadcast partner last night, Jordan Hinman, talking smack about
Led Zeppelin's.
Like, wash your mouth out with sandpaper, bro. What's wrong with you?
Yeah, that's... Well, look.
Blaspheming.
He's young. He doesn't fully understand.
He's not that young.
Yeah,
and then he went after the Beatles. We should all appreciate it.
He went after. Yeah, he did. How dare you? So bad about...
I'll take the Who and Led Zeppelin over the Beatles any day.
I did say I'd take the Who over both.
You can't be mad at
and
the
Beatles.
And that's
why I like Pat Miletich. We're sitting here talking about the Who. We're getting ready for Anthony Lloyd and Josh Richardson to cut it up. Richardson coming down with his team looking very, very confident. Just good times all around here in Davenport, Iowa. If you haven't been to the River Center for one of these things, I cannot recommend it enough. The atmosphere is one of joy, of one of just, you're at the height, you're ready. You're ready to go. You're like, oh, man, it's about to happen. And then it does. I mean, head kicks, knees, arm bars, submissions. We got the ladies every once in a while. Although Jeff's a big
and
refused to call her a lady. I don't know what's wrong.
You cannot say that word. I know you're not a biologist, but... Joshua Richardson fighting at a Peoria Athletic Club, Bartonville, Illinois, raised around mixed martial arts. Doesn't matter who he's locked in there with, he will put on a show. Feels like his experience, 10 years plus, will be the difference maker. Looks up to somebody we all know, Matt Hughes, who is in the building tonight watching his son, Brandon Mills, who will be fighting later on tonight's card. He's been around forever, and he's seen it all.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Lightweight Division, powered by Squirrels Tree Care. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 6'1" tall and weighed in at 154 pounds. He trains at Marty's Martial Arts. Joining us from Rock Island, Illinois, Anthony Lloyd. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'10" tall and weighed in at 152 pounds. He trains at the Peoria Athletic Club. Joining us from Bartonville, Illinois, Josh Richardson.
Anthony Lloyd, Josh Richardson, about ready to make it happen.
Richardson just staring him down across the cage as he paces back and forth. Here we go, baby.
What do them poll numbers look like?
We got Anthony Lloyd still as the favorite at 60.71%, and Josh Richardson closing the distance at almost 40.
Well, Josh is going to have to do that very thing of closing the distance because Anthony seems like he's got a few inches on him.
Oh. Richardson already turned his back a little bit there. 1-2 from Lloyd.
Piecing him up here against
the cage. Good body shots from Lloyd.
Big.
Anthony is unloading here in the opening moments of this first round.
Some more body shots. Good knees.
Oh,
those are
that
solid
we were
knees.
Talking about
oh,
last
hurt.
Night.
He's really
he's
hurt
definitely
right now.
Hurt.
His body's done. This could be over very quickly. Richardson swings.
Anthony absolutely unloading.
See if he can survive this onslaught. Lloyd talked about his endurance being better. We're about to find out. Oh. He was throwing a lot of stuff there.
Yes, he was. And Richardson works out of it, to his credit right there.
Caught that low leg kick that Austin.
Good knee
Anthony
right there. Knee from Richardson. And they are trading knees on the inside with this clinch work.
No shortage
Ooh,
of toughness.
Good uppercuts are getting through. That's three in a row. Four. Body shot from Richardson.
That's where Richardson should be taking advantage of being in close against a taller guy.
Without a doubt. He's definitely tough, man. He's withstood some serious shots.
There's that big knee gets through. Richardson eats it.
Not a mark on Richardson.
Which is amazing, because some of those are definitely getting through, Pat.
I think some did, but...
Lacking on the power,
that left
maybe?
Just got through. There's another left.
Overhand right.
How scary is that, though, to be unloading everything and the guy's still there with no blemish?
Good inside leg kick from Josh Richardson right there.
Well, that's where you, I mean, adrenaline at the beginning of a fight. You heard it.
Ooh, left,
nice
right.
Good
leg kick.
Bit.
Ooh, good right shot from Lloyd.
Nice combination.
Hurt right there.
1 minute left.
Richardson doing the right thing, crowding him, putting him up against the cage, taking a little rest. Now, with a little less than 1 minute in this round, Pat, how does Josh Richardson take over and take this round?
Well, definitely hit a takedown if he can, but, you know, certainly.
There it is right there. It's good.
You know, now he can at least stop being sponsored by Rawlings Catcher's Mitts. I mean, that's important.
It is.
I mean,
it is.
Don't stand around and take abuse.
Moving to side control right there.
Get out of the way.
Got his knee over to the side. Steps over, doesn't get there.
25 seconds left in this round. There's those knees you're a big fan of, JB.
You know, you got them. Why aren't you taking them?
Super easy to
move. There's another
right
one right there.
If he wanted to
move. I like those two knees.
If he wanted to move to the left, up toward the head, it would create space for his right leg to slide across to the mount very easily.
There it is. He heard you.
5 seconds to work with that. He might have
He's
him.
Under there. Is he
Three,
under the chin?
Two. One. He fights enough. We'll see another round.
Mr.
Now, let's talk about that. Anthony Lloyd dominant on the feet. First 2 minutes. There were some exchanges. Then we get the takedown. Josh Richardson moves into side control. Takes a while to mount.
Lloyd's round.
Think so, huh?
Easily.
With that.
Yeah, easily
that
round. Yeah.
Next question. If there's 20 more seconds, does Richardson get the submission?
I think so.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that's a big spoiler. I mean, you think about that.
Yeah.
You could have won the fight if you just took advantage of that takedown a little bit earlier. Instead, you're losing the round, according to Pat Miletich.
And maybe, just maybe, his coaches are telling him exactly that coming into the second round.
See a right get through and a couple body shots from Lloyd on the replay.
Lloyd just absolutely unloading here in this first round.
Here's one of those knees coming up. That's into the body. That was the big one that hurt him.
Not only just punches and bunches.
And here's the side control steps over.
Is.
But again, just a little too late to take the round, according to Pat Miletich. And he takes the neck there. I'd say he would be hard-pressed to get out of that with 20 more seconds.
Well, we'll see how this second round pops off. That's a good, probably, moral victory for Richardson after being pretty much pummeled during the beginning of that first round.
And Richardson closing in on the polls after that, 41% plus.
That makes sense.
If you think Richardson's going to take this fight, head over to cageaggression.tv, baby. Ooh, right catches him. Left hand from Lloyd.
Followed up with a nice right.
Lloyd likes to lunge in. Easy time, great time for Richardson to get a takedown. Take advantage of that.
Didn't quite catch the low blow, but apparently the giblets were grazed.
But this might not necessarily be a bad thing for Lloyd. You know, he's got 5 minutes. You know, he's pretty active in that first round. If there are any cardio issues, he's getting a breather right now. Extra minute or two.
Well, he was lamenting his cardio before, saying how dope it was, but we'll see.
Well, he's back in there right now. Ready? Leg kick from Lloyd lands. Head kick from Lloyd.
Switching up his strikes. It's always good to see.
Knee on the inside from Richardson. Knee from Lloyd. Ooh, overhand right.
Big shots. I don't know how much they're hurting Richardson, but he's definitely landing and
Richardson
scoring.
Looked like he blocked a little bit of those lefts, but that right
digging
got
in. He's digging again. Certainly get his back off the cage. Put Lloyd against the cage.
Which he just did. Coach, he's listening to you.
Maybe you need to be talking if you want that Richardson
down.
There it is.
There it is.
He's got time to finish it now, almost 2 minutes.
Yeah, he's got plenty
Absolutely.
Of time. Going for that mount.
He's trying to step over like he's getting on a horse. Don't want to do that.
You want to slip it in there, a little slicker
well,
than
that? Well, slide it across, you know, wedge it across the waist. Right now he needs to push down on that knee and just slide over to the mount.
Anthony
moving up toward the head. He should get the mount pretty easily here.
He's doing the best he can there to keep him from getting that full mount. Got him in half guard here.
Burning time, too. We're at a minute 15 left in the round. Richardson not getting a ton of offense off here.
Looking much better than that first round, though.
Well, it's got, he got the takedown an extra minute before, you know. But again, looked a lot slicker with that takedown going into mount and then getting that neck than right now.
See what Lloyd's doing to the leg there. He's got a lockdown on it that keeps the shorter guy from being able to move up your body and get the mount. It's a pain in the butt unless you know how to get out of it.
Which is?
You basically want to drop down like you're hitting a double leg and then plow your legs backwards, sprawl out of it, and then move off to side. Side control there.
30 seconds left here in round number two.
30 seconds, Josh.
Josh Richardson finding a little bit more success here in the second round with Anthony here taken down. Certainly a Richardson round in my mind, although he didn't get a ton of offense, controlled the almost the entire round, really, other than the first 45 seconds.
One round apiece. Makes it fun going into the last round.
Absolutely. Make or break.
Right hand.
Show me something, Blue.
There's that lockdown again on the leg.
All right, Coach, you tell me. Both corners, what do you say? Obviously, it looks like there's a round apiece for each of them.
You know, for Lloyd, I mean, control the center of the ring, use your reach, score your points that you need. You know, don't get tied up with it. And Richardson, of course, time is when he lunges in, you know, when Lloyd lunges in with his strikes, easy takedown. Get it, get to work, get mount, start punching like a madman, make him make a mistake, and, you know, look for the gate, right?
Love every second of it.
Yeah, definitely would love to see Lloyd use that reach advantage. Keep him at the end of those strikes, big long dowel seam legs.
Well, the girls pulled out the belly chains tonight. It's Saturday.
Oh, yes, they did. Listen, there were belly chains last night, my friend.
Lovely Serena.
You just weren't looking too close.
No,
huh?
I wasn't.
We're not quite cage side where we are.
Yeah, we're up front and up close and personal, man. We get to see all the hail damage.
Jeez.
No, in the ring, in the cage.
Yes,
the ring.
Of course. I'll tell you what, the crew had to go to work. There was some bloodbaths in there.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. They worked hard last night.
They had the full-on cleanup crew.
Yes, they did.
Touching up here, round three. Anthony Lloyd, Josh Richardson.
Leg kick from Lloyd.
There
Lloyd lunged it in right there.
Again. There's the takedowns.
See, I like it when Lloyd's 1-2 like that. That wasn't a lunging 1-2 at all.
Ooh, nice
Lloyd
overhand
Richardson
right.
Connects. Oh, Richardson really looking to close the distance right now.
Nice angle there by Lloyd.
Very much
right
so.
Hand.
Yes, it was.
Good knee on the inside of the body.
Lloyd not. Yeah, good Richardson. Job, good coaching by Lloyd's crew.
Tell him to separate, keep that distance.
There's no steam left on his punches, though.
I
time
see
for
that.
Richardson to get after it.
I noticed that in the second round, too, actually.
Ooh, uppercut. You know,
he's scoring, but he's not really doing much damage with those.
If I'm Lloyd, I'm looking at good. That's what I'm looking for right there.
Big
closing
knee.
The distance, knee. Oh.
Richardson takes a finger to the eye.
And that's rough when you kind of have that Muay Thai open hand stance. You know, a lot of people say there's some kind of solution with magic gloves. I've seen some coaches try. Is there really a solution, Pat? I mean, don't you really need your fingers and your digits to control, especially in mixed martial arts in those close situations?
Well, and if you're, you know, Chael Sonnen, you want to use those digits to poke people in the eyes.
I knew you were going
right?
there. I
so,
knew
I mean,
you were
that's
going
important,
there.
But no, but ultimately, I mean, it's going to happen because people gauge distance by reaching out like that. Boxers do it. They just happen to have boxing gloves on, right? Everybody does it, so it's just, you know, it is what it is.
Well, you'd have to get rid of the plum clinch almost. I know a lot of people like the palm-to-palm better, but also prying somebody's fingers apart. It's a big
right.
thing in submissions.
Right.
Yeah, John Jones is pretty well-known for that, too, slipping those fingers in the eye. Nice straight kick there from Anthony.
Less than 2 minutes to go in the fight. Right now, really anyone's fight.
Richardson needs to get a takedown and go for a submission or just pound him out and win.
He's pretty much 1-1 here. How are those polls looking? They tighten up at all, JB?
57.5% for Anthony Lloyd. 42.5% for Josh.
Cats closed a little bit.
Lloyd's.
Oh,
ooh, big left.
Lloyd gets kicked or caught.
Lloyd's staying busier, though, ultimately. He's probably winning on points this round.
Yep. Nice check kick there. Anthony.
Countering. He's got him up against the cage right now.
Time is not on his side. He's got to get busy.
Just over a minute. Got to get it.
Looking to it. Yeah.
Another takedown. Is that the difference maker, guys?
If he can get them out and start pounding him out, he's got to score points with it. That doesn't win him the round. He's behind still no matter what, unless he starts inflicting damage. And the mount is there. It's there all day with Lloyd.
It really is. Or knees.
You know what? He opened him up
there
with the
is.
Knees before, and but that made him really uncomfortable, and then he was able to step over. So I don't see why not go back to that, get two or three knees in, step over, and that could be the fight.
So he's trying to get that slide over.
Lloyd's just a longer, lankier guy. It's easier
there
to mount
is.
Those guys.
There.
30 seconds here.
Time is not on his side to see what he can do here in the last 30.
Comes down to, I think, not only does he.
Yes,
who
keep
wants
doing
to
that.
Win
do
it.
That. Come on, those strikes are hurting. Do them again.
They're there
then
all day.
Score.
But having the ability and knowledge from here to win it.
He's definitely not capitalizing as much as I would like to see him do with him on the ground, but I don't know. I think those knees and the takedowns might be the difference maker.
I don't think there was
the
any mustard on that sandwich. So
take
you're
down.
Going Lloyd, huh?
Lloyd absolutely won that
I think we
round.
Might have a split decision here, Pat Miletich. We haven't
so?
Had too many. Yeah, I think it's going to be a tough one. You know, like you said, there wasn't a lot of mustard on those punches in the third round.
But he was scoring.
He was scoring.
Stand busy. Stand busy.
Yeah.
But then you have the eye poke, stops the action. You know, the judges kind of look down. From there, Richardson takes control, takes him to the ground. Not a lot there. Not a lot of mustard on those knees either. We'll see where they go.
Punches and bunches and strikes and punches.
Close fight either way.
It definitely is. As we kick off night number two. Night number three, I'm sorry, with fight number two. Been a long weekend.
Let's leave it off right now.
Like I said, wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
Wish it was.
Not yet.
You should have that two rounds to one because of your takedown. It's your job.
Look.
Anthony Lloyd, Josh Richardson. Close one. Closely. It looked, you know, Anthony looked like he was, you know, his game face on with that first round, man. He came out blazing.
You know, there were a couple fights last night that I thought could have been split decisions, and I was really surprised one of the judges had that 30-27, but, you know, we didn't get any splits. We'll see right now.
See some of the replays here. Josh with some nice counters.
Richardson coming forward there. Landing some uppercuts of his own.
Ring announcer, Casey Barkas, getting ready to let us know who picked that up, W.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to your judges' scorecard for our decision. Our judges scored this contest 29-28, Lloyd, 29-28, Richardson, and 30-27, declaring your winner by split decision, Anthony Lloyd.
All right, Anthony, hey, man, first of all, congratulations on such a tough-fought victory. I know you've been waiting a little bit to get back in the win column here in Caged Aggression. Talk to us how it feels now, man.
Oh, man, it feels pretty good. This is my first win, so first time getting to talk to you.
Well, hey, look, I wanted to tell you, you know, and I heard it cage side all night, you look like a different Anthony Lloyd in here tonight. What'd you work on? What'd you do specifically to prepare for this fight against Josh tonight?
I was just working on my hands a lot, just the striking fundamentals. Unfortunately, I had a rib injury during training, so I didn't get to train as much grappling as I wanted to. But the game plan was to keep it on the feet and outland them. And I think I did that.
Well, look, I have to agree with you. I think the game plan worked out tonight. You got the dub. Now it's time for the celebration. But before that, anyone you want to mention? Anyone you want to thank?
Just a shout out to my corner, Marty Perez and Dave Severe. Shout out to all my training partners that helped me out. I appreciate you guys. And thanks for everyone who came out to support me.
Enjoy the rest of your night, sir. Soak up the victory. Let's hear it again, ladies and gentlemen, for your winner, Anthony Lloyd.
You know, when it ended up being a split decision, the only thing I can say is that 30-27 seemed kind of outrageous. You know what I mean?
Yeah, the crowd here was not a fan of that.
And again, I thought that Josh Richardson could have won that fight. Very closely contested fight. I thought it did come down to the third round. I said I thought we were going to see a split. We finally did see one. But a 30-27, I mean, again, how do you give the second round to Lloyd in that fight? I just can't see it.
You win some, you lose some. Kudos and shout out to Anthony Lloyd for not only picking up the win tonight, his first W as Austin Allen makes his way to the cage. Aggression Cage, the Shed, fighting out of the Shed. Pettigo, submission, fighting out of Bushnell, Illinois. His father was a Golden Glove boxer, been boxing and training throughout his whole life. Thoughts on this matchup? No real thoughts, he says, just ready to fight. Some of the difference makers he feels are grit. And we've seen a lot of that this weekend. I mean, these guys have come in with a serious will to win and actually no quit in their game. Looks up to Mark Hunt, Daniel Cormier. Not bad company. Interesting stories about his MMA career. He was thrown into a Golden Glove tournament for the very first match. Knocked down with an uppercut. Was stopped with a nose for a nosebleed, but gained instant respect because of that grit. And again, we saw a lot of that this weekend, man. Tattoo may have picked up the L, but showed a lot of heart. As he faces off, Austin Allen faces off against Brandon Roberts, who will be making his way to the cage. Austin's a big boy right here, Austin Allen.
You know, as a fighter, do you want on your tombstone, was a tough guy, or showed a lot of grit, or wrecked human beings? I would prefer the latter.
I bet you would.
It doesn't have to be mutually exclusive, man. You can have them both.
Well, we had a similar discussion over dinner with Matt Hughes and his son yesterday, and we were talking about you don't want to be the tough guy in the gym. You don't want to be the toughest guy in the gym.
No, because you're definitely not going to win any spelling bees after that. You're just not. It's not.
Take it from a guy that still speaks very well, Pat Miletich, and got punched in the face for a living.
I can't remember where my socks are, though.
Oh, I think you can.
Brandon Roberts making his way to the cage. A little mob deep right here out of Red Shaver MMA, Chilton, Wisconsin. Got an MMA in college. Ready for a good show, he says. Think that his grappling and his striking will be the difference maker. People, he looks up into the game once again. Bruce Lee.
Red Shaver, former UFC competitor, longtime competitor, very good grappler, won a lot of grappling tournaments. Red Shaver went up against old Nick Ackerman many, many years ago. Nick Ackerman, former two-time NCAA wrestling champion. Nick won the Hodge Award, actually, the Heisman Trophy of college wrestling. And Red Shaver, after that match, said, who is that guy?
The Hodge Award after Danny Hodge, right? The guy was crushing apples with his bare hands up until his 80s.
And he was about 145 pounds and could, with the old cars, the old automobiles, could just walk up and twist the handles off the doors of cars.
Jeez. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Heavyweight Division, powered by the Sneaker Vault. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands an even 6 feet tall and weighed in at 259 pounds. He trains at Pedigo Submission Fighting and Team 8 Man and is sponsored by Western Illinois Detailing, 365 Roofing Company, Westside Lumber, Conkler Creations on Facebook, Crossroads Building Supply, Family Chiropractic and Occupational Health Services, and Snap Fitness 24/7 Macomb. Joining us from Macomb, Illinois, Austin Allen. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'10" tall and weighed in at 243 pounds. He trains at Red Schaefer MMA and is sponsored by Flex Fitness Systems. Joining us from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Brandon Roberts.
Brandon Roberts there during that announcement did not take his eyes off of his opponent here.
He's got the hips going over there.
He's ready to go. Don't go to the bathroom. Don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. The hammers are about to swing.
And Roberts coming in at the hefty favorite, 66 and change, over Allen at 33%. And they are getting to business early.
Big boys can end it quick.
Yes, they can. And one hitter quitter.
Swinging for the fences right there, Roberts.
There you go, mixing it up right here in front of us, the broadcast table here. Nice straight kick caught by Brandon.
Allen also swinging heavy.
Moving pretty quick for big guys.
Ooh, left catches him.
Yeah, it doesn't take much with these big boys.
Hands are low. Hands are low.
Austin's definitely hands are way low.
Closing the distance on him is Roberts. Puts him up against the cage. Knee from Allen. Roberts tries to return, doesn't quite get there.
Roberts going for the takedown here up against the cage.
Not getting those tree trunks off from underneath him like that.
Not anytime soon.
Ooh, oh, big right out. Left connects as well.
Austin eats it.
Pushed forward while it happened.
Yeah, he did.
Austin Allen needs to keep that right hand up, that sweeping left hand coming at him quite often.
Brandon trying to throw some feints here, keeping him guessing. Nice straight left there from Allen.
That's a pretty quick straight punch for a heavyweight.
Yeah, both guys are pretty agile.
Yes.
We saw that last night in the Jordan Trowers fight, man. His opponent, that big boy, was moving well.
Shorty Baker.
Shorty Baker.
Got clipped coming in that time.
Yes, he did. A little over a minute to go.
Oh,
big right.
You loaded up from Tennessee on that one, buddy.
Ooh, big leg kick as well.
Call that one the Knoxville.
Nice low leg kick from Brandon.
It's a close round right now.
Yeah, I'd like to see Austin get his hands up a little bit more, man. That big boy like that could end your night quick.
Both guys have connected. No takedowns. Good leg kick there from Allen.
Switching up those strikes.
And they've been pretty reserved. I mean, these guys, you know, they haven't gone crazy. Look very focused. Nothing out of control. Very measured.
I was just going to say, I mean, you got to
Especially for some of the big wingy punches early
yes,
on.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you almost thought it was going to be just, you know, a barn burner of a brawl, but it's gotten pretty technical.
20 seconds
right left
here.
They're trading right now with 20 seconds to go. And right lands from Roberts.
And they're not walking in with reckless abandon, man. They obviously have some respect
no,
for each other's
you know
power.
What? Roberts is 1-2, and he's out of there a lot of the times.
That activity, that flurry toward the end there.
There's 1-2-3, and he goes for the shot.
Got to give Allen the round because of some of this stuff.
Allen was very sharp, and you know what? His jab was much sharper.
Like you said, he delivers it with some quickness for a big man.
But
Roberts?
Roberts was doing a good job here against the cage with some flurries and stuff, and then that takedown attempt. He's showing offense and attempts, which may sway the judges because it was toward the end of the round, because most of the round was fairly close, right?
Yes, it was.
Very, very close.
Absolutely. And, you know, everything's about angles, right, Pat? You know, some of those shots may look like they land when
right.
they don't.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, you can't miss it when Allen's landing with that straight right. It's right through.
Right.
And with these big boys, you got that big question mark of who's got the gas tank and
There's
the cardio.
There's one of those right hands right there in their replay.
Shots there.
One of those kind of lunging in moves there that Allen's done a good job of countering.
Well, he countered it, but Robert still pressed forward and caught him.
Yeah, without a doubt, without a doubt.
You know, that's kind of the story of this fight. Even when Allen's getting hit, he's moving forward as well.
He's a tank. Here we go, round two, touching up in the center of the cage. Austin Allen, Brandon Roberts, fight number three of night number three. Cage digression 33, a lot of threes tonight, this weekend. Ooh, big left. This guy's got, Brandon's got a chin. Looks like he's either cut or got a little mouse over his right eye there.
Allen's bleeding a little bit there.
Ooh, big left from Allen gets through again.
Wow, these guys are eating some shots.
Left gets through for Roberts right there.
Little pawing shot there. Nice good little leg kick.
He needs to do that more and hurt him.
That definitely hurt him.
And being the shorter guy,
nice.
That can help him close the distance.
Man can't move. He can't fight. Nice big left from Allen.
I think Roberts could land it all day long if he'd set that up with the jab and just throw the kick. He could get it all day.
Left hand lands for Allen. The thing is, Allen might want to switch it up to a right hand. Roberts has that left hand so low right now. Coming in.
Inside leg kick.
Super low. There's a good leg kick from Allen. Slightly checked from Roberts. Left hand catches Roberts. And that's the thing. There's not a lot of setup with that right at all. And that's why Roberts' hand is over there.
Well, and as much as Allen throws the left hook, you just want to roll with it and throw the low kick when you roll with it and absorb it. So you land there. All their weight's on that lead leg, so you can bury the kick as hard as you want. You know they're not going to pick it up and check when they're in the middle of that left hook. Just roll with it and land that kick.
Close fight with a little over a minute to go in the second round. Left right from Roberts.
There's that leg kick.
Good leg kick from Allen. Another good leg kick
doubling
from Allen.
Up,
tell you what, Roberts didn't seem bothered, which he hasn't really seemed bothered by much.
Right. Both guys exchanging left hooks there.
Loading up. Great to close this night out.
Roberts continues to push forward after those two leg kicks, and they were solid. There's another leg kick. He gets caught on the counter. Roberts bothered him with that shot. Goes for the takedown. Slip that left. Nice takedown. Great dump. And now he's got about 35 seconds to work.
Let's see what he can do with it.
Well, he's got the Red Schaefer background at his gym, so he knows what he's doing on the ground.
I think regardless, this probably wins him the round in the judge's mind because, again, it was so close. It's such a close back and forth.
Right.
And Roberts.
He's landing now.
Yes, he is. Oh,
sticking to him.
Right back in on him.
About 10 seconds to go in this first round. Roberts trying to put on as much shots as he can.
Landing a lot.
Yes, he is. Tough to see how he's getting right through, but very uncomfortable for Allen. Let's see what happens at the end of the round and how quick he pops up. Oh,
wow. Closing seconds, man. That was all Roberts.
Busted him up a little bit. He's bleeding more. Roberts doing a good job there. Roberts looks in way better
condition. Yeah, I was just going to say.
And it looks like Roberts knocked his mouthpiece at one point there. Allen breathing a little heavy in the corner.
Not leaking too bad from that left, that right eye, rather.
Call that an abrasion.
Minor laceration. Brandon Roberts, definitely, like you said, champ, looking, taking some breaths there, but he's definitely looking fresher of the two fighters.
Oh, yeah, he's ready. He's hungry.
And Brandon Roberts right now, the heavy favorite at 64% against Austin Allen.
Up off his stool, looking confident. There's that takedown. Nice job yanking those legs out from underneath Allen.
Austin's corner with that inswell all over that right eye.
Countering the low kick with the right hand, which is textbook.
Said JB, Brandon, the hefty lead on the poles there.
Here they go, they touch him up. Final round in this heavyweight fight. A very fun one, back and forth.
Brandon talking to him there.
Right hand gets through for Brandon Roberts.
Switching it up. Austin returns with his own leg kick there.
It's a pretty technical fight for an amateur heavyweight fight as well.
You're correct, my friend. It's cool to see.
I love it.
That cage aggression doesn't put on that outlaw mud show. They bring talent up into here. Slow and steady winning the race here for both of these fighters. They're more methodical on how they execute their offense here.
Left hand lands for Allen.
I need more punches now.
And Roberts right away faces him. You know, that turned his head a little bit, but he was just, again, he just ate it.
Austin's corner calling for more shots, more punches here.
Yes, it did. He backed him up a little bit.
Mentally, you got to know, you got to feel when you land something like that. You know it hurts them, even though they don't show it. Go right back to it.
Yeah. Blocked a little bit with that shot there, but I know it still stung. Some big boys throwing some leather. Minute 35 seconds here in the third and final round.
Ooh, Allen catching it again with that straight
right. Whoa. Looked his head back, snapped it.
And you know what? I would have liked to see more of that in this fight because he really didn't utilize that straight right enough. It was that left, that left, that left. Well, and that hand was pretty low.
And as an amateur, you know, you don't have a ton of experience in that. When you throw the power knife straight down, yeah. Oh, he's mounted now. Yeah, yeah.
This is
trouble.
Bad news in a minute
ugly.
More.
This is ugly.
Roberts looking to finish this thing. I don't know if he's going to get through, but he's looking like he's dominating right now.
A minute left in the mount.
A lot of time.
Allen doing his best to try to, you know, not let his hands get through, not trying to fight back from the bottom.
Austin Allen, though, not working his lower half of his body to work his hips and his legs out of this position. So right now he's dead in the water. See, he's just not doing anything with his lower body.
And Robert's kind of looking for a transition into the armbar right
now. Looks like
it.
Definitely looks like it.
You know, taking his time. I think he realizes at this point this is probably his round no matter what. Trying to soften him up. See, he's looking for that arm. Up and right there. Allen Smart bumps out a little bit. Still looking for that arm, yeah.
Dude, that was a 1-2, and right before the 3, he turned and stopped that pin.
I love it.
Right?
I love it. Nothing WWE about this one, folks. These are real heavyweights mixing it up, and it looks like Brandon Roberts has sealed the deal and gotten this victory. With a dominant performance in the last minute of the third round.
Good fight for amateurs. Now.
Absolutely.
Very much so. Very fun fight.
The big men put on a great show here, man. Like you said, for amateurs, very tired.
Well, how many times have we seen in a big heavyweight fight, you know, it's over in 90 seconds, or it's a 5-round boar fest because they blow their loads in two rounds. I mean, this had everything. A lot of technicality, people pushing forward. Brandon Roberts really just edging him out on the skill set. And listen, it wasn't easy for Brandon Roberts.
No.
He had shots that would have put me in the next week. I wouldn't be broadcasting, folks.
Sleepy time.
Yeah, sleepy time.
Brandon is out, man. That brother is sapped. Incredible gutty performance by both fighters. I do believe this is Brandon's night, though. Austin Allen taking a little quick siesta right here in front of the broadcast table.
Tell you what, I like Austin Allen's hat. Jens Pulver was wearing his hat a similar way with the brim up.
Jens Pulver can do it however he wants to. That's Jens Pulver, bro.
He does it big, that Twitch streaming maniac. And, of course, Miletich, what? Pretty much Hall of Famer, folks. I mean, it doesn't get better than Jens Pulver. It doesn't get better than Matt Hughes. And it certainly doesn't get better than Pat Miletich.
I would hope that we don't have to actually beg anymore to get Jens in the Hall of Fame.
I mean, you shouldn't have to at all. You know what? I like him working with the UFC. I think it's coming.
It's coming.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
You know, I think it's coming as well. He's a pioneer in the sport, just like you, Miletich. And he's really fun to call fights with as well.
Yeah, Jens is quite the character.
Roberts digging it in the corner, all smiles, feels he solidified the win, as I do as well.
Yeah, he definitely did enough, more than enough. Tough matchup with these boys.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to your judges' scorecard for our decision. Our judges scored this contest 30-27, 30-27, and 29-28, declaring your winner by unanimous decision, Brandon Roberts! All right, Brandon, congratulations on the win tonight. I know it wasn't easy. How's it feel coming away with such a tough earned victory?
Feeling incredible. Feel like all the hard work paid off. No feeling, no words can describe this feeling.
That's understandable. Well, look, I wanted to check with you. Is there anything you want to mention or anyone that you want to thank before I let you get to the locker room?
Yeah, I want to thank the best ladies in my life, my girl, my mom, all the coaches at Red, all my teammates. Couldn't have done this without all of you. So I just want to be proof that if you have a dream and you're willing to work hard and you believe in yourself, you can do it. So don't hold back.
Great message. Great fight tonight. Enjoy the win and the rest of the weekend, Brandon. Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen, one more time for your winner, Brandon Roberts.
Here we go. Congratulations to Brandon Roberts, picking up a very tough, hard-fought victory right there. Tough kid with a nice positive message there at the end as we move into Gavin Lewis against Davari Thompson. Gavin Lewis making his way to the cage, fighting at a regular fight team. Wanted to stay active after he finished wrestling. Thoughts on the matchup? He's excited for it, and he feels his wrestling is going to be the difference maker. We will see. We will definitely see as he will be facing off against Davari Thompson here momentarily. How's that poll looking, JB?
We got Davari Thompson at 40% and Gavin Luze at 60%. Eric Koch talking to his fighter right now, giving us some words of wisdom and getting ready to enter that cage.
No better learning tree to sit under right there.
Yeah, Eric Koch's put out a lot of very, very good fighters.
Yes, sir. Eric Koch is the man. He had a lot of fighters fighting this whole weekend, actually.
Wonder how his voice is doing.
Yeah. Surprised mine's holding up as good as it been over this last weekend.
Well, you get to a point where you just have to whisper to your assistant coach in their ear and tell them to yell. That's how bad it can get.
Gavin Lewis making his way into the cage, aggressive cage, as he awaits his opponent, Davari Thompson, fighting out of Iowa Top Team, Linden Scrap Shack, Linden, Illinois. Started BJJ after high school, took an interest after playing UFC video games with friends. Interesting transition from video games to the real world.
You're in a couple of those games, aren't you, champ?
Yeah, I was at some point, I think.
You're in the, well, I know you are because I have the EA Sports MMA with yourself, Boss Rootin, and other legends,
okay,
my friend.
Okay.
You know, I'm a bit of a vintage collector, you know, back
yes,
in the day when you were
you
kicking
are.
Heads instead of just talking heads.
You know, when we pulled up the EA Sports, actually, when they had me come down to Tiburon down in Florida to help them design the game when I went down there, was the day after. Well, we pulled up, the vice president of the company picked me up at the airport. We went and had lunch. We went to Tiburon, pulled up in front of the building, looked up, two giant Tiger Woods PGA golf banners on both sides of the building. The day after, he got himself in a little bit of trouble. I asked the vice president of Tiburon, I said, hey, one of those banners coming down. He goes, shut your mouth, Miletich.
Bad PR, baby. Davari Thompson feels this is going to be a good matchup. Feels this needs to fight to long to avoid the takedown. Thinks his length, kicks, and distance management is going to be the difference maker. Looks up to Eric Wisely and the one and only Nate Diaz. As these fighters get ready to do the thing here.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Welterweight Division. Powered by Old Town Heating and Air. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 170 pounds. He trains at Regulators Fight Team. Joining us from Oxford, Iowa, Gavin Lewis. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6 feet tall and weighed in at 170 pounds. He trains at Iowa Top Team and is sponsored by Baldwin Builders, WingmanOfTheYear.com, Pete's Flooring, Profit Gear, Green Mountain Pinball, Shine Entertainment, KT3 Fitness, PS Ult Historic Bird, and Game Calls. Joining us from Linden, Iowa, Devari Thompson.
You know, both of these fighters ready to go. Sorry about it.
No. You know, after pronouncing Gavin's last name wrong, because it is Lose, I'm hoping the guy can go totally undefeated in his career, and it's Gavin never going to lose.
Gavin won't lose.
I mean, that's a great gimmick right there.
Doubling up on the outside leg kick of Devari Thompson. Lose having him up against the cage here, going for a takedown.
Thompson did a good job of stuffing that. He's got one arm locked up.
Devari is long champ, and you're right. That's what he's saying. He's hopefully going to use that length advantage.
Well, Luz is doing the right thing, right? He's putting pressure on the cage. He's trying to take away that length advantage, and it looked like he was going for a takedown.
Yeah, trying to block the leg and tip him over and stuff, but you got a very long guy that knows how to use his leverage, can give you nightmares. He's already going for, he was going for a darce there originally.
And they worked their way out.
Back to separation there.
Ooh, big punches being thrown. Devari Thompson with a nice front kick. Good leg kick by Devari Thompson.
Trying to keep that distance.
Tell you what, Devari Thompson looks very composed on his feet.
Gavin walking through those leg kicks.
There's a guillotine. It's tight. But he got it. Oh, he got his head out. Sorry.
So let's see what Gavin can do from up top, because this is definitely where he's trying to take the fight from the very beginning.
Yeah, it's negating any leaked advantage that Devari might have here.
Thompson needs to walk those legs up there.
Hanging onto those arms from the bottom. Gavin getting them loose. It looks like it's just a matter of time. And there they are.
Gavin loose, though. He's being in the guard of a long, tall guy can really be dangerous. And it's a
there it is, and he's
butt.
Looking already.
It's really
for the
difficult
triangle.
To land strikes at times. You got to get half guard or cross sides on those guys on the ground. There's a kick to the groin.
That one was uncomfortable. Yeah.
Don't let him get up.
Yeah,
back down. Yeah, that's right, Bruce.
Referee, Bruce. Good job, Bruce. As you were.
Luz has got to get past those legs.
Ooh,
there's a leg lock.
It's
heel
tough, though. Oh, he's going for it.
Heel hook.
Oh, he's in there.
He's got to get hooked on the forearm. He's got it correctly.
Oh, he's got it. Got him back down.
Just needs the feet on the hips. He's got him crossed to stop him from coming in.
It's in there now.
He's locking it up a little tighter right there, getting it out by Gavin Luce.
What's Devari need to do to cinch it up, champ?
Well, he needs to use down closer to where a wristwatch would be on his wrist to lock that radius bone in underneath the heel.
Oh, he's
fun
out
back
of it.
And forth here with 30 seconds to go in the first round. Thompson looks uncomfortable right now. He looks really uncomfortable.
Gavin's
something's wrong.
Firing away.
Something's wrong with Thompson. He either got up or off, or he's running away. He almost turned his back. That could have been the end of the fight. 13 seconds and a takedown.
Good job by Thompson.
He needed that. He absolutely needed that.
Hitting takedowns on the wrestler. You can see the red marks on Luz's left lower leg where those low calf kicks have been hitting. That's an indicator of go back to that.
Nice
interesting
back and forth
fight.
There.
Yeah, where do we
nice
go with
first
this
round?
Who takes that first round? Is it Gavin or is it Devari?
I think it's very close, but the way that Devari was reacting there was a lot of timidity that may stick in the judges' eyes
yes,
their minds,
in the final minute.
Yeah.
After the exchange on the ground where he was rolling, he may have had that knee bar into a heel hook.
I mean, those reactions were one of an individual having 100 people throwing rocks at him.
Yeah, the turning of the back and running away.
Well,
yeah,
he didn't quite turn his back. You know, he went to the side. But if you do turn your back, that's it. That's the wrap. And here's some of the action right now. There's the submission attempt. Here's Gavin getting some shots in. There was some early striking. There was that leg lock attempt.
And I mean, look, that's offense, right? The leg lock, the heel hook.
Absolutely.
He's definitely attacking, so, you know.
It's a close round. You know, I wouldn't be mad at the judges either way, but I think you're right. You know,
Luz pulled it out.
Yeah.
Well, like you said, Jason, Devari did look rather uncomfortable there in the end of that first round.
And he looked extremely comfortable in the first 2 minutes. So I'm wondering what happened.
This is where it's changed.
Oh, he caught him. He dropped him. Referee Bruce Allen stepping in, stopping the match. Devari Thompson getting dropped by Gavin Luz in the opening seconds of that second round.
Something happened, though, mentally.
Well, like Jason was saying, the
first round,
yes. Yeah, the fight complexity changed after those first 2 minutes when they got up. After that, you know, that roll in exchange for a submission, not quite sure what it was.
Lou's unloaded on him with the hands, and it's something mentally.
All I can say, Gavin, is you were the favorite in the polls, and if you can keep this up, you got a great nickname, Gavin Never Gonna Lose.
Impressive performance by Gavin Lose, without a shadow of a doubt.
And that could change to Rarely Will Lose.
And not gonna lose this time.
And then if he stays in the sport too long, it'll be Sometimes I'll Lose.
It'll slowly change over the years.
And then, so we're not gonna go there. We're not gonna go there.
Incredible performance by both fighters. Jeffery with a nice job in that opening first round, but something happened, like you said, boys, into that first round.
Also, I'm saying is you make lemons out of lemonade.
The sweetest
of store of sport with that last name, you know.
Lose who?
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, has called a stop to this contest at 9 seconds into round two, declaring your winner by TKO, Gavin Lose. Gavin, man, what a statement to make tonight. Looked like you started off that first round in a little bit of trouble there, man. What was going through your mind, and were you ever concerned?
No, I wasn't concerned, man. I mean, he's a great fighter, but, you know, we train pretty hard, so I was trying to stay calm, cool, and collected. That's what they preached to me, man. So I just did my best to stay calm, make it to the second round, and here we are.
Here we are. So, look, you mentioned training. You mentioned all that. You came in tonight giving up a little bit of height to Jeffery, man. What was the plan as far as dealing with that goes?
I mean, there was no real game plan. I don't like to cut a lot of weight. I think it drains you. So I'd rather come in here healthy, ready to go.
Understand that. Well, look, I'm going to let you get to the celebration. But before I do, I'm going to let you pay some bills. Anyone you want to thank? Anyone you want to mention?
Man, to my friends and family that came out, I heard you guys. I appreciate you guys. Thank you. And, of course, my coaches and my team. Man, I'm grateful for them, man. I wouldn't be here without them. I got the best team in the game.
Well, look, we're definitely looking forward to see what the future holds for you. Enjoy the rest of the night. And let's hear it one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner, Gavin Lose.
Congratulations again to Gavin Lose, a very impressive performance as we move to our next fight. Judah Bolzer against Brandon Mills. Brandon Mills, obviously the son of former welterweight champion and Hall of Famer, former student of our broadcast partner, Pat Miletich, Matt Hughes. Judah stepping into the cage here, fighting out of ground zero in Fairfield, Iowa. Got into MMA because of his friends. Looked at this as a good opportunity to represent his gym. Feels that his experience is going to be the difference maker, and he looks up to one of the greats, GSP, as well as Nate Diaz, who I saw today is trying to ask him to get out of his UFC contract.
I didn't see that, but a little bit of bad blood saying GSP. You know, GSP and Hughes obviously having quite the feud, and, you know, that's where GSP came into his own. You know, GSP in that first Hughes fight came close, didn't quite get there. Matt Hughes took him in, and then, you know, that GSP era went on for a very long time after
that. Yeah.
Looked like a whole different fighter with that win he got over Matt, but both fighters obviously greats and in the Hall of Fame without a doubt.
Right. And then they did another fight that was kind of, they pulled Matt in last minute on that last fight between those two. And I thought that there should have been some stipulations on that in terms of testing and some other stuff that should have happened.
Sure.
Where if Matt was willing to take that fight on last minute, that the testing could happen at any moment.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was
absolutely
something that
and,
I
you know,
thought.
That's just another scandal in the GSP era. Everybody knows about the greasing, which was very obvious, and then banned from the UFC. I mean, that was something so obvious that it was like, oh, my goodness.
As Brandon Mills gets ready to step into the cage, makes his way, fighting out of American Top Team. Fort Dodge, Iowa's his hometown. Got into MMA, I guess, by his dad, Matt Hughes. Looking to make some huge improvements over the last fight. He's got a style he know he can beat, which echoes your sentiments in our opening stand-up there, champ, to start the show off. You were saying he needed to make some adjustments.
And he feels his conditioning, his youth, and his wrestling will be the difference maker. Got into the sport from, again, his dad and Rocky Marciano. Grew up watching his dad fight. Had a huge effect on him. He's been living and training at American Top Team for a while now and training with the best in the world, where iron sharpens iron.
And I was just so impressed when we had dinner with him last night, Pat. He was talking about how he didn't feel that ATT was intense enough sometimes, and he was taking secondary practices with some of the Dagestanis and the Russians. That shows you this kid has the eye of the tiger. He wants more, more, more.
Well, and look, I say it all the time. The guys that are winning in the UFC and that have always won in the UFC are the people with the immigrant mentality, and those guys happen to be real immigrants. I was born here, but the immigrant mentality had to be there to win.
Absolutely, and again, those are the guys that he's rolling with, and that's why maybe he's at 78% as the favorite.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Division, powered by Elite Loyalty Management. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'7" tall and weighed in at 146 pounds. He trains at Ground Zero MMA and is sponsored by Bradfield Blasting, Arrowhead Tattoos, and Chelsea's Spa. Joining us from Fairfield, Iowa, Judah Bolzer. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'11" tall and weighed in at 150 pounds. He trains at Pfeiffer Licks Martial Arts and American Top Team and is sponsored by Full Contact Fighter. Joining us from Fort Dodge, Iowa, Brandon Mills.
Brandon laser focused on his opponent. Both of them got their game face on and ready to rock. Here we go, Brandon Mills. Judah Bolzer, it's about to go down. Here we go, let's see how this plays out here. See if Brandon has made the necessary adjustments from his last fight.
Sponsored by Full Contact Fighter. We used to wear that back in the day, buddy. Joel Gold from New York City bringing that back.
I like it, I always loved that logo.
Yeah, that's the original. It was down between Full Contact Fighter and Tap Out for getting the UFC, the first UFC sponsorship percentage deal. And they decided to go with Tap Out, and Full Contact Fighter kind of faded away. But Joel Gold has never given up.
Good for him.
I need some of that gear.
You hear that, Joel? Champ's asking for gear. Nice inside leg kick from Brandon.
Look at the shoot. Bolzer puts Brandon Mills up against the cage right now.
You know, Mills needs to work his striking in this one. He's got the opportunity. He's taller than his opponent.
Mm-hmm.
Needs to circle out, push off, use his reach.
Nice knee from Boulder.
And start working on getting comfortable with the striking in an actual fight. It's one thing to hit mitts and spar in the gym and things like that, but super important to get comfortable in the cage in all aspects of it. So he does. He pushes off. Good.
Ooh, good nice right from Mills.
And
goes into a takedown.
On a double.
Let's see if he can get him up.
There he goes. Oh. It looked like pops right there.
And again, when you're working with those Dagestanis, they love that dump.
Yeah. Got to put his knee on that arm and pull his arm out.
A little over a minute to go in this first round.
Putting his knee on it. There we go.
Oh, and he's looking for that mount. Crosses over.
You got it. Yep. Yep.
A little high. He gets taken off. And he's in a bad spot. He's up against the cage
right
now.
Yeah, it's an awkward spot there for sure.
Still in the top position.
45 seconds left here in the beginning of this first round.
There's the full mount right there. Let's
there
see what he can do with it for 45 seconds to go.
Ooh, got
looking
it
under
back.
The neck. This could be it. Trying to soften him up. He's under the neck again. Bolzer grabbing that hand.
Bolzer doing a good job of defending.
Yes, he is. He's got the phone booth going. Mills with under 30 seconds to do some damage here, riding his back. He's got both hooks in.
And flatten him out.
Just keep punching. Let him look for the gate.
He's under
he's
there.
Under there.
Let's see if he can lock his hands in.
14 seconds.
It's getting tight. It's getting tight.
Got him flattened out.
He's yes, down. He taps him.
Whoa. With 7 seconds left in the first round, Brandon Mills with a very impressive first round submission victory over Judah Bowser.
Textbook performance right
yes.
now. You know, and he took a big knee when he had him up against the cage, you know. He readjusted, got him to the ground. He was very patient, got him away from that cage, got the mount, and ended up getting the submission.
And look at first round. I still would have liked to have seen him work on his striking a little bit more. You know, at this stage in his career, this is the time to do it. Definitely get that part of the game honed. But, you know, look, when you're in the fight.
And you're the son of Matt Hughes. It's a big dump on the ground, ground and pound,
yeah,
punish him guy. I mean,
right.
He's the guy. I mean, you might as well call him the mini Mark Coleman.
Brandon coming over talking to the champ. Ever developing, Brandon Mills, a nice victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 51 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by submission due to rear naked choke, Brandon Mills. Come on over, Brandon. Hey, you keep your record perfect here in the camera cage. Talk to us how you feel after that big win, sir.
Well, first off, let's keep that undefeated record going, but that one's definitely much more exciting than the last time, much more improved. Felt great.
It looked great. So you mentioned working on your striking a lot before coming into this one. What was the game plan coming into this fight? I mean, very, very tough veteran fighter here you face tonight.
Well, the plan was to make him unconscious, but he tapped before that, so I guess it all worked out.
There you go. Well, look, it was definitely a great submission, great buzzer beater. I wanted to ask you, though, anyone you want to thank or anything you want to mention before I let you get to it?
Thank my whole family and my team for getting me this far and supporting me throughout this whole journey. And shout out to all my sponsors. Too many to name right now, but thank you guys for supporting me.
Well, thank you again for the performance tonight. We're looking forward to see what comes next. Until then, let's hear it one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner, Brandon Mills.
Impressive W picked up from Brandon Mills, making Pops proud with that performance as we move on to Rafael Ramos and Levi Kilroy.
Rafael. I'll tell you what, Ramos is pumped up.
He's
coming
jacked
out
up,
there.
Baby. Fighting out of Team 110 out of Chicago. He's always been a martial arts fan. It's just a matter of time before he eventually tried MMA. I feel like this is going to be a stand-up fight, so one of us drops or the fight gets stopped. Feels his strengths are going to be able to move his game plan where the fight goes, just wherever he goes. He's comfortable wherever it takes him. And another big fan of GSP. Rafael's definitely looking pumped here, ready to step into the cage and get after it.
Came out to the chainsaw music. I don't know this one, but I ain't mad.
Oh, yeah, he's jacked up.
He's ready to go. As he awaits his opponent, Levi Chaos Kilroy. Nice amount of scraps so far, boys. Nice amount of scraps. How's that pole looking for this one, JB?
We got Levi Kilroy coming at the heavy favorite. Oh, just changed. Went from 74 down to 64 and change. So Ramos is gaining ground, gaining some more. Almost up to 40.
Must be Ramos's walkout music.
Hey, I like it. I like it a lot. I mean, it's no Tool, right, Pat? I know you just experienced your first Tool concert the other night.
Oh, that's right. You guys hit that up.
Very entertaining, very talented. Very interesting.
Interesting indeed.
Thought-provoking.
Looks like we got some tape issues going on the gloves of Rafael.
And as those issues are going, Ramos is gaining ground again and again. So
you're watching on pay-per-view, take part in the polls. Who's going to take this one, Rafael Ramos or Levi Kilroy?
Trying to stuff it in there instead of cutting it off, looks like. A little pause for the cause here as they try to administer some...
Oh, we got some cutting going on. Here we go.
Some removal of some tape here on the gloves of Rafael Ramos.
You're watching the nitty-gritty inside baseball right here of MMA.
How the sausage is made.
That's right.
Bunch of gauze hanging out.
Now, can that harm him in any way after you wrap your hands and now all of a sudden you're cut parts off?
Well, it just comes unraveled and causes problems during the fight, you know. And so it's more of a...
annoyance?
Well, it's more of a, you got to stop the action to fix it later on if you don't get it taken care of now, right?
Yep.
Eating my breath mints. Don't want Jeff cringing.
No one likes dragon breath.
I had some monkfish earlier.
Oh, wow. Oh, did you hit the bistro?
Yes.
Oh, two nights in a row. Look at you.
Duck City Bistro, best restaurant in Eastern Iowa, Western Illinois. And I would put it up against any restaurant on the planet that I've been to.
Well, we had dinner there last night before the fights. It was absolutely excellent. And they also, up on the board, were promoting some caged aggression.
Sweet.
Trifecta, all three nights, baby, as it comes to a crescendo here on Saturday evening. And Levi Kilroy makes his way down.
Fighting out of the basement in Rock Island, Illinois. Watch local guys like Frank Young, somebody we saw fight this weekend. Didn't quite come up with the W, but still a tough aim ever. Good matchup stylistically, high-level striking. His strengths are going to be his jiu-jitsu, specifically his triangle chokes.
This building is full, gentlemen.
Hey, it has been all weekend. It's been really impressive. A great vibe, a good time. And that's why I told people, listen, if you're in the Quad Cities area, if you're in the Midwest, get down to one of these events live. You will not be sorry. The atmosphere is great. The times are good. And the fights are gravy, baby.
Yeah. Mandates and all the nonsense is over. The house is packed and the card is stacked. It's been an awesome weekend, man.
Absolutely.
Been an awesome weekend. We're only halfway through here, night number three. Still a lot to go. Levi Chaos Kilroy getting ready to step into the cage, aggression cage, to pit his skills against a very game and ready to go Rafael Ramos. I saw Brent Cooper, who fought last night. Didn't quite go the way he wanted it to, but still a very, very tough individual. Walking Kilroy to the cage. Levi steps into the cage, getting ready to do work. Having a little discussion.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Lightweight Division, powered by Iowa Auto Club West. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 6 feet, 2 inches tall and weighed in at 155 pounds. He trains at Team 110 and is sponsored by E&R Transmission and Peluco's Garage. Joining us from Maywood, Illinois, Rafael Ramos. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall and weighed in at 154 pounds. He trains in the basement. Joining us from Rock Island, Illinois, Levi Chaos Kilroy.
Here we go.
He's not even up here. And we are about to do this, Ramos versus Kilroy.
Both these fighters chomping at the bit, touching up in the center of the cage. Here we go. Ramos swinging with a nice low leg kick there. Nice return with a front kick from Kilroy.
Both guys wearing tie shorts.
Both these guys hitting up those low leg kicks. Trying to negate some of that mobility with a lot of those low legs. Whoa, big one there from Ramos.
Lots of leg kicks back and forth in this first 30 seconds.
The man can't stand.
Ooh, there's another one.
Got to check those kicks,
ooh,
man.
There's another one, man.
Ooh,
again,
wow.
He's going to that well.
Ramos doing a good job.
Hey, if it ain't broke, don't break it.
If they're not going to check your kicks, might as well tear their legs off.
He's continuing to do so.
Yeah, he's lighting them up with those low leg kicks.
Good straight left, pushing them back.
Ooh, there it is.
That one landed. This could be over quick, folks. Ramos does not look like swarming him here. He didn't look like he was letting up when he was coming down to his music, folks. He's all over him. He's trying to get under that neck.
He's under there.
He's softening him up. He's got a lot of time. It's almost over.
He's got him back.
This one's a tap.
It's a tap. Here it is. It's right there, ladies and gentlemen. The opening moments of the very first round. Pumped up Rafael Ramos is feeling himself after that very impressive victory. And he was just eating that leg up, man. That was just a matter of time.
Well, Kilroy not checking those kicks led to that loss. One very simple act of defense could have shut all that down.
Well, like you said, champ, when you find success with it, just keep going for it as Ramos.
And he did that. You know, he mixed some other things in there. He had that straight left. He backed him up.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't just go to the striking. When he saw him covering up, he said, I'm going to take that back. Really impressive performance by Rafael Ramos.
He's hobbling a little bit on that leg. You see some
might be hobbling a little bit for a while. Yeah. Some of those things sounded real solid.
Yeah, good Muay Thai kicks.
You get the winner of our main event, night number one, Dominic Martin over there, the Heat, in the corner of Kilroy.
There he is, locking on the rear choke.
Yeah, he came to fight. Got that body triangle.
Yeah, he even locked in the body triangle as he was pulling back. I like this.
You know, he was more than content with keeping it standing, but the fact that he dropped him with that leg kick.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 15 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by submission due to rear naked choke, Rafael Ramos. All right, Rafael, man, congratulations on the big win tonight. Came out, set that tempo going into intermission. I gotta ask, man, you applied a lot of pressure early on. Was that the plan coming in?
Always. Leave him absolutely no pressure to breathe. You make mistakes, I capitalize on it. That's the game plan.
You were saying something early on before the fight started to him. What was that you were saying to him?
Oh, well, I was telling him if he wanted to touch gloves before or at the beginning of the round. Like, I'm down for either one, but...
I got you. I couldn't tell. I thought you were calling your shots or something like that. Well,
sorry. I want to do a quick shout out to Manny Vasquez. He's getting married today. He's one of my teammates. He wasn't able to be here. Again, he's getting married, but happy journey.
Well, I was going to ask you, too. I didn't know if there was anything else you wanted to mention or anyone you wanted to thank before I let you get to it.
I just want to thank my team and my sponsors, ENR. That's where I work. Pelucos, also a really good shop if you guys need any work. My teammates, they have been there throughout the whole camp. They've received major beatings and they've given it to me, so I thank you guys. But yeah, thank you. Thank you guys for having me here at Caged Aggression. I'll be definitely looking forward to fighting for you guys again.
I think there's a lot of people here looking forward to seeing you back in action in here. You definitely bring the pace, you definitely bring the action. But look, I wanted to let everyone know, let's hear it one more time for your winner here tonight, Rafael Ramos. Tonight's card, we're going to take a brief 10-minute intermission. When we come back, we're going to have the main portion of tonight's card, including all of our professional fights. That's coming up here in just 10 minutes.
Wow, what a way to kick off night number three, man. We've seen some first-round stoppages. This last one, Rafael Ramos came in with his game face on and ready to go, just start eating that leg up of Levi Kilroy. Got a really ridiculous deep rear naked choke in there to pick up that first-round victory. A very, very awesome performance of the ever-developing Brandon Mills. What are you guys' thoughts on what we've seen so far?
It's been very exciting for amateur fights. We've seen some very high-level. We've seen some amateurish mistakes as well, but overall, you know, very good quality fights, and we're obviously going to be looking forward to some professionals later on in the card. But, you know, talk about the Corey Armstrong versus Jake Bauer first fight there. You know, I mean, when we go back through, they have rattled off
finish after finish, other than the heavyweight fight, which was a technical masterpiece for an amateur fight
for heavyweights as well. But you know, Jake Bauer getting the first round KO. Unlike last night, there were some long, drawn-out fights, right? I mean, there was. And so tonight, totally different. And on paper, you never know. We talked to Mike Goodwin when he does these matchups. Ideally, he wants the fights very close. Sometimes they're very close. Sometimes they go the distance. And then other times, fights on paper that you think are going to go the distance do not, like tonight, right?
Absolutely. Still looking forward to this main card. I can't wait to kick it off.
Well, like you said, on paper, like last night, man, Mike Plazola and Sean West, everyone expected that one to be a stand-up banger. First round submission from the exception, Sean West. Again, we are only halfway through this, ladies and gentlemen. It has been a long but amazing weekend. We've gone through two nights of incredible matchups. Again, thanks to the whole Cage Aggression team for what you guys have done to help this weekend make it possible.
Yeah, so going back through, Gavin Lewis against Thompson was a very good fight. Lewis just was able to get that fight figured out. You go to Brandon Mills, who Matt Hughes' son, obviously I'm going to talk about him. You know, he did a very good job. He landed some good striking. He looked better on his feet tonight than he has in the past, which is where he wanted to improve. I would have liked to have seen him work a little bit more on his feet, just simply because he was fighting a guy who was probably a little bit slower, probably, you know, a little bit older and not as tall, so the reach was there for Mills.
But not hard to be older because Brandon Mills is only 20.
Yes. And Brandon Mills made fun of me yesterday, and he said, I said, who are you fighting? And he said, well, he's your age.
he's on that AARP, bro.
Yeah, so that was good. But, you know, so the first half of the card's been very good. And, again, Ramos, very solid Muay Thai.
Looked like a buzzsaw in there.
And changed up everything. And, you know, you see a guy with Muay Thai shorts on with very good Muay Thai. Go to the ground, get the finish with the submission. So,
you know, great
job by him.
Coming. Looking forward to the co-main event, Nico Jefferson and Michael the Battleship. Gabriel Mota, big heavy-handed cat going up against another heavy-handed cat in Cedric Savage. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. Part two of night three of Cage Aggression 33. The trifecta is coming your way.
Hey, everybody, Jason Bermas here for CagedAggression.tv. I am with the co-main event of the evening, Michael Shipp. You are standing up against Nico Jefferson. Tell us how it's going to go down.
Well, as most people know, I was originally supposed to fight Nico last October, but unfortunately, and it was devastating to me because I've only had to pull out of one other fight in my career. I had to pull out due to injury, but luckily, Mike thought the matchup was good enough to make sure it happened, so we are here now, and I couldn't be happier to be back here. Weight cut and camp went great. As far as the fight itself, I know Nico is a great stand-up fighter, and everyone knows how good my grappling is, but my grappling's always going to be good. And I've always taken pride in my stand-up progressing throughout my career. So, and I've always believed that a true champion should fight his opponent where they want to be fought. So I'm going to oblige Nico with a stand-up fight tomorrow. That is not to say I will not take it to the ground. I mean, anything could happen. Instincts kicked in. We'll see what happens. But I can promise the fans a banger right now.
Well, you told me that the camp went great. The cut went easy. Tell us a little bit more about the camp, because obviously you're coming off this injury. Did you have to do anything differently? What was it?
Well, the injury was a very specific part, so all we did was just keep it protected. If it gets hit a certain way, then I might have problems, but it's got to be a very specific way. So there's a long shot on that one, but it's good to go. Focus a lot of stand-up in this camp. Didn't really advance the grappling much, just kept myself crisp on that. Might have a few new tricks to show tomorrow night. We'll see what happens.
All right, Michael, we wish you the best. Is there anything else you want to tell the fans out there in Caged Aggression Land?
Looking forward to seeing you all tomorrow night. It's been over a year since I've been in the cage, and I'm on a mission tomorrow night to come out with a victory, so I can promise you are not going to want to miss this.
All right, Michael, best of luck to you.
Thank you very much.
And we are with the co-main event of the evening, Nico Jefferson. He's fighting Michael Shipp. Tell us how this one's going to go down.
It's going to be a good fight, man. I know he likes to bring it. I'm definitely going to bring it. We were supposed to fight back in October, but he had an injury. He actually sent me a message on Facebook. So, you know, we spoke back and forth, and he said we'll run it next year, and he kept his word, and we're here now.
We are here now. So how is the camp? How is the weight cut? You seem pretty good right now. You seem pretty calm, focused.
Absolutely, very focused. My last fight here, it didn't go the way I wanted, but I was able to do some things I wanted to do. I was able to land like everything I wanted to land, and I got hit with a knee, ended the fight, so that left a bad taste in my mouth. And I'm definitely ready to, you know, show what I can do.
All right, my friend, we wish you the best in the cage. Anything else you want to say to the fans?
I thank everybody for the support. We're here. I appreciate you. Everybody's definitely, I got a lot of people ordering the pay-per-view and also coming to the fight. So I come from Illinois. It's not only a couple hours, about 2.5 hour ride. So I got a lot of people supporting me. So I appreciate all of them.
Excellent, Nico. We wish you the best.
Thank you.
All right, and we are with the main event of the evening, Cedric Savage. He's going against Gabriel Mota. Tell us how it's going to go down.
This ain't leaving the first round. Either one of us is going out. We're two warriors in there. This is what goes down when you got two individual athletes out there ready to put in a show.
So you're telling me it's going to be a slugfest?
Slugfest right off the gate, baby.
How did the camp go and the weight cut? You look great for 205. You look flushed out. You look ready to go.
I've been working all year. So when he called this, I was ready to go. So this easy on my day. He's on my part two fights right here. I'm ready to go. He's ready to go. He's coming off of fucking, what, KOs? Yeah, I'm ready for that shit. I want some of that.
Well, I got to tell you, I'm excited. You seem excited. Anything else you want to say to the fans out there?
Be ready. Be ready. Don't blink.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we are with the main event of the evening, Gabriel Mota. I hope I'm not butchering that. He's going up against Cedric Savage. And the last time you squared off in the Caged Aggression cage, you threw bombs and got that KO. Are we going to see the same thing tomorrow night?
Man, like I said the last time, man, you know, he's going to come forward, I'm going to go forward, and somebody's going to get knocked out.
Well, tell us about the camp. How was the camp, the weight cut? Where's your head out in this one?
Oh, man, it's like every other weight cut, every other camp. You know, it's just do work, come out, put an exciting fight for everybody that comes out and watches. I was supposed to fight another guy, and then I got him like 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago. So, I mean, game plan's still the same. Go in there, implement my game plan. Just put on an exciting fight for everybody, man. That's all. That's all it is. That's the game plan. Put on an exciting fight and try to look for a knockout.
Well, we're super excited. Is there anything else you want to say to the fans?
Everybody coming out. I got a lot of people coming out from Chicago and Indiana. I appreciate all the support. Man, I'm just excited. I'm excited. I fought last month. I got a knockout. You know, my goal is to keep that streak going. So.
All right, Gabriel. We look forward to it. Thank you so much.
Fans, welcome back to the main portion of tonight's card. A couple reminders before we get it back into the action. Don't forget, head over to the corner over there, visit our friends from the QC Sneaker Vault. Get your custom event t-shirt. Tell them which fighter you're here for. That fighter gets a portion of the proceeds. You get a small piece of history. That's right back there in the corner, courtesy of our friends at the QC Sneaker Vault and Old Town Heating and Air. And once the lights go out here tonight, don't forget to join us for the Caged Aggression 33, the Trifecta After Party, and awards presentation. That's all going down at the Damn View Inn. And just announced, you're going to want to hear this, free pizza to all Caged Aggression 33 After Party attendees, courtesy of Low Pies Pizza. That's all at the Damn View Inn going down after the show tonight.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. Joey Reese getting ready to square off against Michael Boylan. And man, we saw some bangers in that first half as Joey Reese gets ready to make his way into the cage. Gretchen Cage fighting out of Bloomington Team 1 BJJ, Fairbury, Illinois. Wrestled his whole life and loves boxing. MMA was his destiny. Kills his opponent. His opponent has heart and good cardio. He's predicting wrestling scrambles and a high strike count. Feels that his strengths are his wrestling, boxing, and an iron granite chin. Looks after fighters like Anderson Silva, Chuck Liddell, Randy Couture. These guys fought for honor and pride, and he's never been in a street fight. How often does that happen? Will people step into the gym having never scrapped in the street, champ?
I mean, it happens a lot, actually, I guess. But, you know, it's just everybody comes from different backgrounds, right?
Well, and I hear so consistently, you know, I got into MMA to stay out of trouble, which oftentimes means street fights, but yeah, I'm sure you're probably right.
You know, my podcast partner, John Fitch, MMA legend in his own right, he never was in a street fight. He was a walk-on at Purdue Wrestling and then found MMA after that. So he's a guy that's literally never had a physical altercation like that, you know, outside of the cage.
And what's interesting about Fitch is his fight style, which was so gritty and roughing people up, looked like he literally came directly from the streets and the wrestling mat.
Literally just dumping people on the ground.
Well,
and
just a very physical fighter, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, and you were never in any street fights before you got in MMA, right, Jeff?
I was lucky. I never really had to have any problems on the streets, Jeff.
Really? Oh, shit. You can't see me. Michael Boylan coming out to some John Cena around here. Fighting out of Porcellus Training Center, Des Moines, Iowa. A buddy from high school introduced him to the game. Loves it so much as my last 11 matchups. He feels good wherever he's fighting and wherever it goes. He feels his consistent work ethic is one of his strengths and advantages. Anybody who looks up to the sport? Nope. Just me in the mirror, he says. Only 20 years old and will be the best one day.
And let's reiterate that. The man just walked out with a shirt of himself. That's confidence.
That's
he
president.
Walked out not only with a shirt that said Marcus Boylan on it, but with his picture on it as well.
Hey,
so that's a ton of confidence.
Yes.
And those are style points. If you're going to go all the way.
Sometimes you got to be the president of your own fan club, dude.
Yeah,
the captain of your own team, baby. And the John Cena, I ain't mad at that.
And this coach is wearing the shirt as well. If you want to take a look at the viewers watch on cageaggression.tv.
In the red shirt, there's Anthony Purcelli, a longtime wrestling coach and MMA coach and out of Des Moines. Had quite a few fights himself. Very, very accomplished wrestler in his younger years.
It's all about sitting under that learning tree, man. Success leaves clues. You got to pick up on them. Time is now. Michael Boylan, Joey Reese. As we bring a close to this incredible weekend, not quite there yet, but it has been an incredible, incredible weekend, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Lightweight Division, powered by Yabba Dabba's House of Glass. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 6 feet tall and weighed in at 156 pounds. He trains at Team One Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. Joining us from Bloomington, Illinois, Joey Reyes. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6 feet tall and weighed in at 154 pounds. He trains at Porcelli's Training Center and is sponsored by Move Well Iowa, All Pro Painting, The Tree Network, and Hubert's Exotic Pops. Joining us from Des Moines, Iowa, Michael the Ninja Boylan.
Reyes and Michael the Ninja getting ready to get on it.
Very even in the polls. Boylan the slight underdog at 43% in change. Reese the favorite.
Punching up in the center of the cage here. See who leads this dance.
And Boylan going with the one ankle brace, not the dual ankle braces that we saw in yesterday with the violent hippie performance.
Yes.
Wear the ankle brace on the good ankle. If you're gonna do it,
just a little trick, a little faint move. A little, ooh.
He got clipped.
Yeah,
shot for the double after that right hand he took.
Ray's trying to take
now,
advantage
when you say
of that.
The, when you say the good ankle, you're talking about your power ankle, correct?
No, I'm saying
the
if
one
you
that's not
a,
hurt.
If I have an injured knee, I'm gonna wear a sleeve on the uninjured knee.
Well, I like that.
That's the one you go after.
I like
a little
it
bait
a lot.
And switch.
Right.
Big dump right there.
A little bit of wrestling there, an attempted switch there by Reese.
And that's what he said we're gonna be looking forward to. Boylan trying to use the cage there to advance.
So he needed to push off on the cage to create room to actually take his back. Put his right foot up there and push off.
Trying to get a little sweep there. A little, oh, take
attempted,
down.
Attempted switch again.
Reyes with a nice
a roll
defense.
Through. That's something that shouldn't happen. All you got to do is post your arm out or your leg
Reyes
and the roll stops.
Top. lot of time to work here, just under 2 minutes.
Triangle. Quick.
There it is. Whoa. Wow. A
little Plata. A little Plata coming around. Nice shot by Reeves escaping that. Tried to hit a roll through to a leg lock. Reese jumped out to the side to block that.
This is exactly what Joey Reese said.
This is good chain grappling here. This is what I like to see.
We predict wrestling scrambles and high strike count. We definitely have some wrestling and scrambles going on.
Both guys showing good quality technique.
Boylan keeping them close. Reese trying to posture up. Steps back down a little bit. Active with the leg, looking out for submission.
Whoa,
got it in.
Very
how
tight.
Tight is it
he's
be?
Got the leg hooked. Oh, he got out. Nice work. Nice. Just needed to spin quicker to take his back on that.
With less than a minute to go, this is a tough one to score. It's been a back and forth battle here.
Gonna hit a dump attempt.
Plenty of scrambles.
See Reese hooking that leg. Actually. So he's got far side wrist control. Lost it there, but nice.
Both going for the inside leg.
Well, he's doing a good job at turning around right
nice
there.
Nice balance. Wow. Good hips, and straight to the mount.
Very impressive.
20's just under
Boylan,
20 seconds
good
left.
Good job getting back to half guard. Got his underhook.
You know, he turned a takedown into a mount briefly. He's still in the dominant
position. Working back
toward
it. He's working back toward it.
Gets it. Nope. Doesn't quite step out.
Reese, based on positioning, wins this round.
I agree 100%.
I'm glad you do.
I agree 100% on that one. No arguments this time, Mr. Miletich.
What do you know about it, Pat?
Hey, these guys are good, man. This is
yeah,
fun.
Yeah, absolutely.
Definitely a fun first round. Reese still the favorite right now at 54 and change. Boylan down, closing that at 45. But, yes, I believe it's a Reese first round. A lot of high technical work on the ground right there.
Definitely.
Good stuff. Throwing up some submission attempts, transitioning from triangles into omoplatas. Great scrambles, takedowns into half guard. Good yeah, stuff.
Just the raise were predicted, man, scrambles.
And the ability to sense where the daylight is when it doesn't look like it's there, right? That internal gyroscope that wrestlers have since they've been kids, right?
Yeah, that's an interesting phrase, an internal gyroscope. That's so
you,
true.
You get thrown through the air and you land on your feet like a cat, right?
Here we go, round number two, Joy Reyes and Michael Boylan. Bruce Allen. Colin, getting into the action.
Nice.
Ooh, Reese comes in with a 1-2.
Switch and stand.
Boylan with a leg kick. Now we're seeing him on the feet a little bit. Winging punch by Reese. Close to the distance.
See who wins this here.
Reese doing such a good job of taking his leg and making Boylan work for it.
He's got that far side wrist control again.
Yes, he does.
Needs to just get a 2-on-1 instead of grabbing his own wrist there. Now he's on the 2-on-1. Got the back. What's he going to do with it?
Tries to drag him down.
Man, strong defense from Reyes.
Good balance. He's got that leg hooked again.
I tell you, the angles he's given up, I mean, ultimately, Boylan should be getting those takedowns given the angles he's got. I mean, that's all day long. He's got to trap the leg, buckle the knee backwards.
Reese needs a body shot in as he's trying to get some distance here. Can't do it. Finally gets drugged to the ground. All right, now we got a dominant position by Boylan on top.
Got to keep working to his left. Push on that knee. He's got the ankle. Push on the knee with the left hand as well and keep going to the left. Get past that guard. Done all that work to get there. There, now he's working past to get in tight.
Yep.
Nice job by Reese, trying to hit a switch here.
Only so briefly inside control, like you said, now he's in full guard.
Yeah, having a tough time past that guard there, Reese.
And he's got to watch it. He's very active on the ground, and his legs are there for the submissions.
Yeah. Stepping over, working his way past that guard again.
Got the slide leg out. The mount. Oh, full mount.
So he's got to pop that hand off his hip. He can't let him push on that hip anymore.
He's got about a minute to work right now.
Working his way up. He's staying tight. Grapevine in the legs. Wants to stay in that position. He's got to take his legs out of that position on the punch.
Here it is. Here he's trying to posture up. He's doing a decent job of defending.
Absolutely.
Nice job. Look at him sliding that leg underneath. Nice job coming out.
The under.
I can't see from this angle.
Doesn't look like there's anything connected right now. Nope. Just a scramble.
Little
key lock attempt
here. Yeah, key lock
here.
Right there.
Now he's going to go for an armbar here.
Oh, nice transition.
Gorgeous.
Beautiful.
Right away.
Quickly.
So impressive.
Impressive.
That was amazing. Big scrambles made Michael Boylan work for everything. And as soon as he had that position, he rolled into an unbelievably quick armbar.
Boylan should have known that was coming. I mean, Reese paused there in that position and made it easy to see what was coming. Boylan should have known and been able to get out of that.
Man, impressive performance by both fighters for Reyes. My gosh.
That's exactly what Matt Hughes did to GSP in their first fight.
You're exactly right, Jeff.
That exact same setup. But yeah, you've got to sense that coming. You've got to know that's coming.
Michael Boylan with nothing to be ashamed of. Strong effort there, but Reyes is just a little too much tonight.
So let's see the replay here. I'd like to see on the ground the finish there, where the key lock attempt was coming from the bottom, and Reese just turned the corners on him and finished him with it.
Man.
Always got to be aware of the counters that can come your way when you're working on offense.
Boy, then with that quick tap, man, didn't want to lose an arm tonight.
I'd rather not lose an arm tonight.
Yeah.
but keep it.
Like we saw this weekend, man, there was some no quitting some of those folks where their arm was twisted in a really bad way.
One mistake can cost you in this sport. Yeah, often it does. And yes. There's your example.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 37 seconds into round two, declaring your winner by submission due to armbar, Joey Reyes.
Joey.
Mr. Reyes, you continue to impress every time you step into this cage, man. You've improved by leaps and bounds, it seems like, since the last time we've seen you in here. Hey, man, tell us, what was the plan coming into tonight?
I was watching his film, and I knew he was southpaw. I knew, like, for that low leg kick, and I knew, like, the grapple. But I knew if I circled away from the cage, I mean, he got me against it a few times, but I was able to circle out. And I was able to toss him with some of the judo throws. And then shout out to Bloomington Team 1 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. That submission I hit all the time in practice. Someone gets a Kimura on you or something like that, you can always step over the head into an armbar. So.
Well, look, it was definitely an exciting performance. I know we're all looking forward to see what comes next. What's around the corner? Do you know yet?
What'd you say?
What's around the corner? What do you have planned next? You have anyone in your sights?
I mean, I guess that kid was ranked number one in Iowa, so I want a belt next. That's what I'm looking for.
Sounds like a plan. Well, look, before I let you get to it, is there anyone you want to thank or anything you want to mention, something that I might have left out?
Thanks to my parents. They finally saw me win. Woohoo. So they owe me a shot or a beer or something. That's what I'm looking forward to.
All right. Well, hey, I hope you get that shot. Until then, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your winner, Joey Reyes.
Reyes hitting a little duck walk as he stepped out of the cage there, reminiscent of my old days in the old wrestling room. As we keep it moving, Quinn Murphy squaring off against Dalton Armstrong. As Quinn Murphy steps into the cage, directed cage, fighting out of Revolution Martial Art, Iowa City, Iowa. Here we go, champ. Got into MMA to stay out of trouble. Stay competitive and sharp. Feels that his wrestling will be the difference maker. Little LL Smooth J.
I want to hear somebody that got into MMA so that trouble lasts a lot less time, right?
Well, it sounds like that's what
trouble
it is.
Ends quicker.
Right. Well, yeah, when you get into it, for sure. But, you know, like Jens was even saying the other night, man, I mean, it saved his life. You know, and a lot of people, it changed their life, it saved their life.
Whatever we find to focus on, right?
For sure. Positive, man, positive.
Right.
Very, very impressive matchup, but we just saw, man, that was a lot of scrambles like they were predicting, essentially. But Joey Reyes with a very, very impressive impressive armbar there to close that one out.
I would say that's probably the most technical fight of the night, even though we had that heavyweight technical fight as well.
That one was far, far and away the most technical, definitely.
What's that pole looking like, JB, as Dalton Armstrong makes his way to the cage?
We got Dalton Armstrong as the slight underdog at 43.75%. Quinn Murphy coming at 56 and change as Dalton comes down the aisle.
Oh, that pole.
That pole indeed, my friend.
I was going to say he's not fit enough for that other pole.
Well, you never know. It's 2022. No disrespect to Dalton Armstrong.
Absolutely not. Fighting at a Nyquist gym, East Moline, got into the game by watching the UFC. Feels it should be a fun one. Thinks that his power and his will to win are going to be the difference makers. Looks up to AJ McKee. You don't hear that name very often, but
you should. AJ McKee, I mean, he's a guy who was in the sport for a very, very long time, and his son doing big, big things.
Absolutely.
Jason Black from my gym fought Antonio McKee. They had a war.
Nothing but bangers here in Cage Aggression MMA. Shout out again to Mike Goodman, the El Jefe, with the dope matchmaking skills as always. No, nothing lopsided. I don't think I've ever seen a lopsided fight in here, but we've seen so many. Frank Young coming out to the cage with Dalton Armstrong.
And, you know, McKee's son has made big waves in Bellator and really does look like a top-level guy. I'm excited to watch him fight every time he steps into that cage.
Very tight pull. What's it looking like, JB?
We got Quinn Murphy at 53 and change, and Dalton Armstrong still in the underdog at 46 and change.
Quinn Murphy's pacing in the cage, anxiously anticipating his opponent to step in, so they both can go to work. We are joined here cage side with Brandon Jenkins. We've got a fight coming up here in April in the UFC. No stranger to the Cage Aggression cage. Here it goes.
Armstrong getting the crowd going. We like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for three 3-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Featherweight Division, powered by McCarl Family Racing. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 146 pounds. He trains with Regulators Fight Team, joining us from Iowa City, Iowa, Quinn Murphy. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 143 pounds. He trains at Nyquist Roundhouse Martial Arts. Joining us from Moline, Illinois, Dalton Armstrong.
And here we go, we're about to do it. Murphy versus Armstrong.
And speaking of Brandon Jenkins, the human highlight reel, he's joining us as we commentate this fight. How are we doing, brother?
Wonderful. Always a good time at Cage Aggression.
Without a doubt. Touching up in the center of the cage here.
Armstrong, the longer fighter, starting off. Uh-oh, we got a takedown by
Murphy. Big takedown. Opening seconds. Big takedown by Quinn Murphy.
Armstrong keeping the distance tight. Not allowing him to posture up just yet. Stepping over one leg right here.
Trying to pass that guard.
Murphy back in the full guard.
Tough to do with them big long legs, I have to say.
Trying to put him up against the cage, it seems like. He's doing a good job of making him uncomfortable, not letting him posture up. I'd like to see him throw his legs up.
Bring your hips up. Bring your hips up.
Hanging onto those hands.
Yep, got that arm isolated of Quinn. Doing his best, so he can't posture up, so he can't keep that or create that distance.
Stop. really keeping it tight. Quinn Murphy hasn't been able to get a lot of offense off. Some body shots there, but they're light. Maybe opening up that head shot, didn't quite get through.
I think that's what those were for.
Yeah, maybe Armstrong's just looking for a stand-up. Just control him so he can get back up.
He's not throwing up any submissions. There we go. Murphy's creating a little distance, and he's able to kick out. Here
There's
we go.
That stand-up.
Right back to the ground.
Yeah,
and beautiful. This time he's in full mount.
Beautiful
this could
shot.
Be a problem.
Hammer fist from Quinn.
So, Mr. Jenkins, you have a fight coming up at the UFC in a few weeks. Why don't you tell us about it?
Yeah, top 20 guy. We got Drakkar close April 16th. I'm really excited about it. Should be a fight of the night contender for sure.
And how has the transition been going out to Nevada and training there?
He lives there.
Yeah.
Oh, you came from Nevada before this. See, I'm a jackass.
You're not a jackass. And I saw you online. You were training, doing some cardio the other day with Forrest Griffin, former lightweight champion. Love that guy.
Yep, I train with Forrest 3 times a week, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 4. It's been really great having him around. Definitely a big boost in morale for sure.
For sure, man. Iron sharpen iron right there. That guy's...
Well, a big dude, literally shaped like a chimpanzee, and he'll tell you, he'll be the first to tell you, some long arms on him. Yeah, I mean, that's not normal.
He definitely keeps me motivated. He's a tireless worker, even though he's retired. He outworks most of the guys that are active.
That's crazy, man.
And Murphy getting some through right now from the top in guard. Misses with that big right.
Not to deviate too much from this right here, but what is that like out there training in that Apex Center?
It's great, man. They put about 9 pounds of muscle on me. Oh,
really?
He's going for a Kimura from guard. That's very rare, but it is possible.
Ooh, clips him right there. Here's the problem with Armstrong. Doesn't seem to have a lot of offense off his back, and as time goes on, Murphy's getting more and more of these shots through.
Looks very game. He's throwing his arms up. I think he's going to come out very hard the next round. He's a long, rangy striker. I think he's going to have a lot of gas. It looks like he's in good shape.
We've got Eric Koch here in the corner talking to Murphy. Looks like he's telling him to do more of the same. Murphy looking really confident and not even taking a seat.
Yeah, as I say, 1 foot up on the stool.
Yeah, he's got like the Captain Jack look right there in the stool. We're watching some of the action from the top. Here's Murphy getting one through.
Has that pole tightened up at all, JB?
We got Quinn Murphy at 55% in change as the favorite, and Dalton Armstrong at 44% in change. I'd definitely be giving that round to Murphy. And again, I think there's going to have to be quite the adjustment for Armstrong to keep the distance and make sure that Murphy can't shoot on him when he's striking.
He's definitely got that length advantage on him. Let's see if he can utilize that.
See if he can give him a front push kick, maybe some leg kicks low, keep that distance, not let him shoot in. And here we go.
Kick off round number two.
Right away, Murphy going to the bottom.
Absolutely. If it ain't broke, don't break it, baby. Go for what works.
Some shots on the inside from Armstrong. Armstrong looks for a knee. Another knee.
Couple of knees.
Another knee. That one gets through. Another knee.
Should he be staying inside with him? I was just going to say, should he be staying inside or should he be trying to create some distance? And Quinn Murphy taking him down once again.
Turn the corner. Tossed him down. Inside control right now. Seems very comfortable. Armstrong with his feet on the cage.
Yeah, he needs to pull Armstrong away from the cage or to use it to wall walk and flip back over in side control.
Armstrong pushes off the cage a little bit there. A lot of time to work, 2 minutes and 20 seconds. I'd like to see him step over right there and maybe look for the crucifix. Instead, he's going for the neck. Looking for that neck. I don't know that he's going to get there. He is trying to step over the arm.
Yeah, he is.
He's going for a crucifix.
Yes, he is. I like that.
See him trying to isolate that arm.
Not quite there, but a lot of time to work.
He's got to isolate that left arm if it's going to work.
There he is.
Looking for that there arm. Looking for that arm. Americana, is he going to get it? Trying to turn it?
A lot of time.
Really committing and going for that. Armstrong on his side. Oh, he turns it over. Is it quite there? Armstrong trying to take his leg.
He's trying to armbar. If he doesn't watch out, he can get armbar.
Oh, man. That was a nice transition. Got out of it and, like you said, threw up some offense there. Almost took in an armbar. That's actually the most offense we've seen thrown up from Armstrong on the bottom.
From his back, yeah.
left hand connects with for Murphy. Murphy in full guard right now. Ooh, to the body. I like that. It was there.
I think Iowa's the only state you can throw elbows as an amateur to the body, and I love it.
Totally. Really?
Ooh. You should be able to throw elbows everywhere in an amateur fight other than the head. And, you know, even that, you know, strike force back in the day, certain times, they wouldn't allow elbows to the head. They would say it's because of the cuts, but it's such a big tool. And I think that Brandon Jenkins might know something about a spinning elbow or three.
Or two, yeah.
Quinn Murphy with a big right connects. Goes under, dumps him.
Dumps him again.
30 seconds to work here. Very dominant performance. He's going to
Armstrong having a lot
round.
Of time defending against those takedowns. A lot of trouble, rather.
Armstrong looks like he's just trying to stall out and get a stand up. He's going for a left arm though right now. Oh. Yeah, he needs to push off.
Misses with that right. Tries to get a few little baby hammers in there.
Baby hammers,
I mean,
like
that's
that.
That's what those are. Oh, there we go.
That was a daddy hammer there.
Not a super daddy, but it's definitely not a baby hammer.
Yes. End of round number two. That's Quinn all day.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Armstrong making his way to his feet. If I'm in his corner, I say, hey, you got to get the finish, my friend.
Yeah, Armstrong's been on the defensive the whole time.
He's breathing heavy in that corner. Hands on the cage. And again, Quinn Murphy with the captain post.
He's posting up like the Fonz over here. This guy's...
Another day at the office for right? Quinn Murphy right here. And if I'm Quinn Murphy, I'm doing the same thing. We're watching some of the replay right here. Him going for this armbar, this Americana, is where he almost got transitioned into the most offense from Armstrong in that armbar. We can see that.
Big right hand lands. Followed up with a nasty dump.
And honestly, that dump could have been worse, but the cage was right there, and that's where the force was going. He took it to the side.
Well, here, moving into round three, Armstrong has to know that those shots and those takedown attempts are coming.
Absolutely. You know, if I'm him, I want to keep the distance. I want to try to lead maybe with a straight left and an overhand right and see if I can work my offense. I don't want to be taken down, and I want to keep that distance, use my length.
Yep, push gets up the middle, push gets to the face. Needs to fight long.
Absolutely.
Ooh, whoa!
Ooh, it gets
big right hand. Left hits him as well to the left, yes. Right up here in front of the broadcast booth here.
And Quinn Murphy just closing that distance.
Doing an excellent job of it. And it's unfortunate
that... inside. There we go. Another good knee. Good job not being taken down there.
Armstrong back. Oh, he rocked him. Quinn didn't even capitalize really. Here he is jumping on.
It looks like it's going to be
it's
over.
It's about to be over. Referee Bruce Allen's right there.
He's about to stop.
It's
not
over.
That definitely shocked him, put him on his butt.
You got
had
two
that awkward look.
And he gave him that quick second to breathe, but then he jumped right on him, man.
You got two stoppages in one.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
Quinn Murphy on fire. A lot of work for his feet, a lot of ground, but the submission attempts, I liked it.
You know, it looked like Armstrong had like a lot of success in the clinch. When they had some clinch warfare, he was getting his best shots off with his knees, but then he separated with his hands down. And then got hit with a spinning back fist. It happens when you're tired. It's a third round. It's going to happen sometimes.
Fatigue makes cowards out of men, man. That's absolutely true.
And he was on his back a lot of that fight, defending a lot of different movements and offense from Murphy.
Quinn was just having success
all night.
I mean,
personally, I don't even want any baby hammer fists from Murphy.
Was that the first knockout of the night?
No,
it was not. We got a few knockouts.
Yeah, man. Well, that's contender for knockout of the night for sure.
Absolutely.
First one was a knockout. Gavin Lewis, Devari Thompson was a knockout. We've had two so far.
No spinning back
three
right knockouts, here. Though. No spinning back. And, okay, it wasn't a KO right there, but it led to the KO.
It was the beginning of the end.
And we're
sure.
Watching some of that ground and pound action that was the end here in the replay.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, has called a stop to this contest at 39 seconds into round two, declaring your winner by TKO, Quinn Murphy! Come on over, Quinn. Hey, I don't know if you noticed, there's like 100 or 200 people over there that are kind of excited about your win tonight. Tell us how you're feeling, sir.
I feel good. My fans are more than amazing, man. They love me and I love them.
Well, look, you ramped up the pressure and you never let off the gas from the start of this thing, man. We're going to work on getting the finish up there. While we're doing that, walk us through how you set that up and through the rest of the finish.
Honestly, I've never thrown a spinning back fist in a fight in my life, but I do it in practice every once in a while, and we worked on it in the back room with my amazing coaches, and he said it, Manifest Destiny. We practiced that not even 20 minutes ago.
Well, it was definitely nice looking. Hey, look, I wanted to check with you, though. Anyone you want to thank or anything you want to mention before I let you start the celebration? Sounds like there might be a few people waiting over there.
I got to find out still what we're celebrating. It's not up to me. But thank you to my coaches, my family, my friends, my fans, everybody, my teammates. It's going to be a good night for sure.
What's next? Anything planned?
I don't know. Where's Boss Man at? Hey, I kind of want a belt, boss. Help me out.
Well, we'll see what we can do for that. You definitely made a good case for it tonight. But I'll tell you what, enjoy the celebration, Quinn. You definitely earned it. Let's hear it one more time, ladies and gentlemen. Your winner here tonight, Quinn Murphy. Before we start our next bout, I wanted to let everybody know our next fighter coming out right now is hearing impaired. He's not going to hear any cheering or anything like that. So if you want to show your support for him, put your hands in the air, shake your hands around, wiggle your fingers, do all that. Let him know that you're behind him.
Impressive, impressive victory from Quinn Murphy as we move to our next bout. Tyler Albert going up against a very tough young man in Thomas Blackerby. Been looking forward to this one all weekend. Tyler Albert making his way to the cage, fighting at a Peoria Athletic Club. Looks up to his dad. I'm sorry, I'm looking at the wrong one.
I don't have a sheet on him, unfortunately.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's accompanied by Jordan All Smiles Trowers as he dances down to the arena. I'll tell you what, this is what I'm talking about. These are the good feelings. This is that family atmosphere. He's stepping into this cage, and he can't wait to go, and he's got all the support in this amazing arena right now.
Being around Jordan Trowers is that doctor unprescribed antidepressants. The guy is just...
Well, Trowers looks like a Ninja Turtle shirt right there, hugging him. I mean, literally, out of the cartoon. Great stuff. Great stuff.
Took the time to take a picture with my daughter last night.
I saw that.
She tried to high five him. He didn't see her when he was walking back after his fight. So took her backstage. He was nice.
How was the family? It looked like you had a great time last night with your daughters.
The girls enjoyed themselves a great deal.
Awesome.
So it was great. I've worked with them periodically over the years. And all three of my daughters. They understand this sport. It's not violence. It's competition.
Absolutely. Well, you got your oldest daughter down there in Jacksonville State. Yeah.
Down in Florida, yes. She goes to school.
Oh, Jeffery Wilson.
I have to say, she's an incredible athlete. Thomas Blackerby fighting out of Peoria Athletic Club. Looks up to his father. Thinks this is a great matchup for him. Feels great everywhere. Thinks his advantages are going to be his striking, his wrestling, and his BJJ. Looks up to McGregor, his dad, and Dan Hornbuckle.
Ooh, I like the Hornbuckle. Let's get rid of the McGregor.
Hey, come on now. What's he done wrong?
Oh, I don't know.
He's been in combat. I'm talking about Blackerby. He's been in combat sports since 6 years old. Four-time Muay Thai champ. Two-time national champ. This guy's just all kinds of decorated. Fought for the Team USA in Italy.
And he's a veteran of the Caged Aggression cage. We've seen him before. I'm very excited to see him again. Definitely has the entourage with him, the fam, giving out the hugs.
Yeah, definitely looking forward to this one. His dad gave me his most recent update on what he's been up to. Hello, gentlemen. Just wanted to send you a brief note on Thomas Blackerby's recent accomplishment for Muay Thai titles, two-time national kickboxing champ, represented Team USA in the World Kickboxing Championships in Italy last October, got his first international victory and made it to the quarterfinals, finished top 8 in the world for kickboxing.
So you're telling me we got a striker?
Yes. Kid 19, easy.
Also trains in a jiu-jitsu gym that has, I believe, 12 black belts. So no shortage of great grappling over there as well.
Again, iron sharpening iron.
What an amazing future this young man has.
And Blackerby coming in at the heavy favorite at 70% and change. Let's see if Tyler Albert can get the upset.
Been in the game since potty train. Thomas is a beast, but we'll see how it plays out against his opponent tonight in Tyler Albert. He's been staying busy, too, since we last saw him. Been overseas, just staying busy.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for three-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Amateur Lightweight Division, powered by the Damn View Inn. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5 feet, 8 inches tall and weighed in at 159 pounds. He trains at Marty's Martial Arts. Joining us from Rock Island, Illinois, Tyler the Silencer Albert. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6 feet tall and weighed in at 159 pounds. He trains at the Peoria Athletic Club and is sponsored by Great Spirits, Forthright Financial Planning, Central Illinois Combat Club, Golden Era Apparel, Riverside Woodworking, The Human Performance Lab, Takeover Home Services, Blackerby Coaching Systems, Ryan and Jennifer Blackerby Real Estate Brokers with Maloof Realty. Joining us from Peoria, Illinois, Thomas Blackerby!
Thomas Blackerby, Tyler Albert, getting ready to put it down here. Hope you got all your drinks and you don't need to go anywhere because it's going to be hand heavy here.
They mean the center of the cage and hug and let's get it going.
Let's hug and then beat each other up.
Ooh, front kick from Blackerby.
Gonna be great at managing that distance.
Don't kick with a kicker.
Tyler Albert realizing he's the smaller guy, trying to find a way in.
He threw a karate back fist.
I saw that.
He's got a traditional background.
Well, bad idea, Gene's here to be fighting Thomas with his hands so low.
Blackerby lands that leg kick. Very much finding his distance as the longer fighter.
Yeah, traditional background there.
Ooh. Spin kick from Albert.
Blackerby saw it coming, blocked it.
And as the smaller, you know, less lengthy guy, he's definitely going to have to find a way in there. And obviously, ooh, that one.
Oh, wow.
It might be over.
He just stalled him.
He's in trouble.
Yes, he is.
He's looking for the referee to do something, but he's getting lit up here.
I think he felt like it was a low blow. It wasn't. I think it came up high, and it just shocked him. Yes.
Nice. Look at him taking his back. Leg lock attempt there.
Looking for that leg lock is Albert. Not giving up on it. Too low.
Now he's going to another one. He's going to get himself hurt here. Arms trapped.
Yes, it is. Blackerby has that right arm trapped up. Gets it out. Blackerby on his side. Looking maybe to circle to his back.
Blackerby has that leg hook. That's a leg ride from wrestling there. You've got to be careful doing that because that gives a leg lock to your opponent. Look at him.
Ooh, wow. Got him twisted back there.
He's wrenching on him.
Albert jumped out of that. That was a dangerous position there.
And now Blackerby in half guard on top.
About a minute and 10 seconds left here in this first round.
Looking to get that leg out and step over.
Nice work. Arm triangle attempt there. Nice bump out. Got his leg out of the way. Good.
Albert doing a decent job keeping the distance right here.
Blackerby
with 50 seconds
to work. Up kick
to
the head.
It's a fun fight.
Absolutely.
Got to be careful sticking that arm in there.
Yep, he's looking at that arm.
Leg lock attempt again. Blackerby got to definitely be careful of that foot lock there.
Yeah, it's in there. 20 seconds left.
And he's looking for it. He's trying to extend.
Thomas trying to do a little leg work himself here.
Yeah, it's the battle of the heel hooks right here.
It's hurting him.
15 seconds. I don't know that Albert's going to have the pressure there. It looks like Blackerby's extremely comfortable right now.
He's wrenching on that foot.
Yeah,
sure is.
As much as he can.
He'll be a buzzer beater here.
Just got to pinch the legs together better.
Thomas did not like that.
See how his ankle is.
And that's the thing with them not being able to hear the bell. I think he might have thought that in that one altercation that the round was up, and that's why there wasn't an exchange. You know, we had Matt Hamill, who was a death fighter that got very, very far in the UFC through the Ultimate Fighter, and really top level guy.
Right.
I remember his first. Well, they overturned it, but that first big loss was to John Jones,
yeah,
which to me was still a loss.
Yes.
He actually ended up opening a gym out near my way in Utica, New York.
Oh, yeah?
Really?
Yeah, yes, he did. My buddy ended up dating his ex-wife.
There you go.
There's the knees to the body.
Yes, sir.
Let's see if this goes low. No, it does not go low. He's grabbing the groin.
Yeah, I'm not sure what Tyler Albert...
I think those body shots just rocked him.
They hurt, yeah.
They rocked him.
That whole stopping fighting because they think the referee should be stepping in is dangerous, man. Let the referees do their job. Here we go, round number two, hugging it out. He's like, get off me, let's do this.
Ooh.
Hard shots.
Over and out with big shots. Tyler Albert with a big dump on Blackerby.
Good takedown there.
Yeah, that's what he needed. You know, he closed the distance there. There's a lot of time in this fight. Let's see what we can do from the top.
Gotta start punching, get that arm free.
Yes.
Start doing some damage.
Thomas isolating that arm. Got it out there.
Nice sweep.
And Blackberry gets back on top. Stands up. Leg kick.
You know,
looks like he wants him to stand up.
Blackerby showing some great grappling there to hit that sweep, considering he's a kickboxer.
Good body kick from Blackerby.
Big straight right.
Drags him to the ground.
After a stiff right hand.
The action's right in front of us right now.
Albert looking for a key lock on that arm.
Free your right hand and start hitting.
Blackerby stuck to him here, trying
to work on defending these leg lock roll throughs. That stuff should be.
You get somebody that really knows the jiu-jitsu that can take your leg, right?
Yeah, and you just gotta know the indicators of it and shut it down right.
Oh,
big
wow.
Hand gets through.
Man,
firing from the beginning of the end there, Tyler. Really gritty.
Take a shot.
That was a big shot.
Yeah.
Thomas bringing some pain with them shots, man. Takedown right here in front of us.
Stands
back
up.
Up kicks.
Yeah, definitely got to be on the lookout for them up kicks.
Oh,
whoa,
there's one of those up kicks right there.
Leave your head down there. You deserve it.
A little over a minute to go right here in the second round.
Big looping left there from Albert.
Doesn't connect. Another looping left from Alum. Oh, there's a spinning back fist.
Oh.
Missed with the right hand on purpose.
Serious exchange. Thomas with Albert pressed up against the cage here.
Albert going trying to grab that
going
wrist.
To mount.
Full mount here from Blackerby. Lots of trouble. 50 seconds to go. Riding his back.
Maybe going for whoop.
Up. Albert gets out, but Blackerby right back to the top of his back there.
Trying to dig in.
Yep. Looking to get his hooks in. One hook definitely in.
Maybe trying to get some rear naked choke action here. He's got his back.
Working to a figure four on the body, trying to anyway.
I'd almost like to see him take that left leg and try to trap his arm with it.
Always helps.
Always helps.
20 seconds left here in the second round.
Good for Blackerby, the kickboxer, working his ground fighting.
Got that body triangle
in. There it is, the body triangle is in.
Just got to pull the foot up a little tighter. Only 7 seconds left, though.
Yep.
Nope. Looks like we're going to see a round three, although the first two rounds have been dominant by Thomas Blackerby.
It's all Blackerby so far. Body language-wise, Tyler looks a little dejected here.
He's breathing heavy. He's been taking some shots. You know, you're 6 minutes deep with a world-class kickboxer.
Yeah.
And that kickboxer's giving you some ground game on top of it.
Isn't that crazy?
Tyler's been doing a good job, though, looking for a few leg locks here and there. He's just...
Here's some work against the cage. Let's see if we're going to see the spinning back fist. There it is. Into a right hand. Here's some work from the top in full mount. Very high.
Yeah, Tyler's got to do something here, man. It's all Blackerby's game so far. Like you said, Tyler's nothing to be ashamed of. He's in there with a world-class Muay Thai striker, man. He's holding his own.
Ooh, big right. Oh, dude. Uppercut. Knees to the body.
Nothing but bad intentions. Listen, on those strikes.
Tyler
for Thomas.
Albert's a tough guy.
He
less
truly
a man
is.
Of just bent down and taken the L.
Blackerby needs to push off and just stay striking. I think maybe he wants to work on his grappling, though.
Yeah, not a bad idea. Well,
he's backing off right there. Tyler Albert making his way back up. Looking a little bit dejected. Hands high. Still taking the swing.
Ooh, big front kick gets through. Directly to the face.
I mean, he blocked a little bit with the right hand, but boy, that was full force to the chin.
Kind of drug him down with him here. Thomas on top.
Fundamentals.
Short elbow right there by Blackerby. Another short elbow.
Trying to get that knee over to get the mount. Sorry, Jimmy.
Trying to get his foot out to full mount, and he's pretty basically
dropping the ones and twos right in front of us right here.
He's gonna push off on the cage here.
Tyler's gotta move.
Tyler has no quit in him, man.
Tough kid, man.
He's trying to scramble no matter what. He's been in some bad spots.
Arm is trapped there.
Yes, it is.
Kicked out.
Minute 40 to go in this third round.
There's those knees.
Man, those knees are wide open right now, too.
1 minute, 30 seconds to go here.
Stomach, yep. Talk about the knee on the belly and how comfortable that is.
It's not a lot of fun when you got somebody raining bombs down on you, I'll tell you.
Can't imagine it would be.
A lot of submission opportunities from that position as well.
Ooh, big front kick.
Man, my goodness. You can tell Thomas is such a disciplined fighter. Man.
Minute to go in this fight. All Thomas Blackerby. 1 minute, Thomas.
I'd like to see a little separation. Thomas, light him up with them ones and twos some more, man.
Tyler Albert needs to circle off that cage.
And he's got to let the hand.
Ooh.
Oh, big right hand right.
Sheeps.
He is tough, man.
He really is. Damn, so young to be so such a badass. 30 left, seconds
right,
left.
Left, right. Tyler Albert goes for the shot.
Goes for what's worked for him so
leg.
Far.
Oh, man.
Trying to come out the back door there. Half guard series.
20 seconds left here.
Nice
trip there.
He should have been ready to come up.
Tyler taking a look at the clock. We got about 10 seconds left.
Tyler's exhausted.
Oh, Thomas Blackerby has come through that big overhand right hand. It connects. My goodness.
That's it, man. That was all Thomas Blackerby, in my opinion.
Yes.
Yes, that will be a 30-27, I believe.
Tyler Albert, nothing to be ashamed of, man. Tough kid. Catching his breath right here in front of us. Thomas put it on him, without a doubt.
Exhausted.
And he didn't quit. Listen, he took
he
some big
quit.
Shots.
He gave everything
willed.
He had. You know
absolutely.
What?
Exhausted Tyler Albert here, trying to catch his breath.
Looking at some of the action, here's the knees. There's that
front
kick that
kick
got through.
The
boy.
Bush.
Some work from the top. And they're back at it.
Good sportsmanship.
Absolutely.
Great sportsmanship.
I love it, man. I absolutely love it. Cool to see Thomas coming here really, really putting in the work on his ground game, man.
Yep.
Could have rested on his laurels and just struck all day, but ever developing. Express over here. Put on a gutty performance, man.
Let's go to Vargas for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to our judges' scorecard for our decision. All three judges scored this contest 30-27, declaring your winner by unanimous decision, Thomas Blackerby. Come on over, Thomas. Hey, exciting fight from start to finish again. You know, we've come to expect that from you. Congratulations on the win. I wanted to ask you, though, because you earned every bit of that victory here tonight. Did anything catch you by surprise stepping into the cage here with Tyler?
No, I was prepared for everything. I had the best camp of my life. Shout out to Peoria Athletic Club. You guys are badasses. Thanks for pushing me. But no, Tyler was as tough as I thought. I knew it was going to be scrap.
So I know you're always putting in work. You're always looking to keep active. What's next? What's around the corner, Thomas?
Man, Mike, I'd like to get that lightweight belt, get what's mine. I think I deserve it. I don't think anyone here can touch me.
Well, you definitely made a case for that here tonight. I know that we're looking forward to your next trip back here, but before I let you get to it, is there anyone you want to thank or anything that you want to mention?
Shout out to my family, teammates, coaches, sponsors. Thank you to everyone. I couldn't have done this without you. I'll be back here soon.
Good to hear. Well, hey, while we're waiting, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time for your winner here tonight, Thomas Blackerby.
Impressive W picked up from Thomas Blackerby as we move into Devin Seitz versus Alex Coover. Cool to see Thomas work on, you know, some of the things. I mean, the ground game. He's known for his striking, but cool to see him put in some work on the ground. Devin Seitz makes his way to the cage, aggression cage. And we move ever so close to our co-main and our main event of the evening there. What's this poll looking like, JB?
We got Seitz coming in as the favorite at 58 and change. Alex Coover at 41% and change. So if you're watching on cageaggression.tv, make sure to take part in those polls.
Closely matched up here.
We're almost to the co-main and the main of the evening, gentlemen. This one's been flying by.
It has been.
Great card.
Very as exciting. Always, as always. Again, shout out to Mike Goodwin for, you know, just incredible matchups, man. And to do that over the course of a whole, you know, three-night event, like I said, you got 70 fighters coming in here from all over the country, man. LFA veterans, UFC veterans, Bellator veterans, all coming here to perform on the proving ground of the cage aggression MMA cage.
And my favorite, the up-and-comers, man, the Blackerbys, the Mills.
It is so
cool. The young
cool.
guys, when you see that face, you're like, is that kid still in high school?
I know, right?
Yeah.
I mean, my goodness.
Very young.
Is this past your curfew, bro? Well, I mean, some of these fighters aren't even legally able to drink, let's be honest, you know?
It's past my curfew.
Stop it.
Well, and the explosion, you know, pioneers of the sport like Pat Miletich, I mean, we've seen such an explosion of the sport. I joke about it, but you got kids coming out of the womb with blue belts or, you know, in the game since potty train or whatever phrase you want to use. These kids, man, are coming in with some skills.
100%. With the right coaching, starting out early, well-rounded games.
Devin Seitz getting ready to make that step into the battleground.
Swings in there, ready to go.
As he awaits his opponent, Alex Coover, coming in from Absolute MMA, Redfield, Iowa. Grew up around wrestling MMA his whole life. Most of all of his cousins and uncles have fought or currently fight. It's a good matchup, he feels, as always, from Mike Goodwin. Like I just said, Mike puts together the matchup like nobody's business. He feels like he's better all around. He just needs to be calm, cool, and collected, and he'll get his hand raised.
Have to be careful over there in Redfield, Iowa, right? If everybody's fighting, whole family. Sounds like,
well, time
family
again.
Reunion's got to be fun.
You see how many champions just in wrestling Iowa continues to produce. Right. Well, a state of 3 million.
For most, you think that's an anomaly, but clearly it's not, Mr. Miletich. Yeah.
Well, I mean, look, the state is mostly flat. There's no winter outdoor sports, so to speak, of. You know, there's no mountains to ski down. It's not like a big hockey state. So, you know, farming, generally farming states and areas, in wintertime, customarily everybody went inside and just beat each other up. You know, you go in the barn.
And they have farmer strength. Let's get that.
That is very real. It's very real.
Very real.
And that's wrestling season, too, you know? Feels his strengths are going to be wrestling, grappling, power, cardio, toughness. His cousin, Johnny Hollywood Cage, grew up around him, and he's been guarding me down the path.
Trained like Extreme Johnny Hollywood Cage. I love that.
Trained at Extreme Couture in Las Vegas for a year. 10-2 amateur, 7-2 in title fights. So he's coming in with some pedigree, man, ready to show his skills tonight. Devin Seats and Alex Coover getting ready to get on the good foot and do the bad thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout of the evening is scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Professional Featherweight Division, powered by Ducky's Formal Wear, Galesburg. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'6" tall and weighed in at 146 pounds. He trains with the Chosen Few Gym and is sponsored by Tattoos by Aaron, Wisconsin's Best, Suter's Speed Shop, Burtness Chevrolet, Edge Tree Care, 608 Smoke, and Dab Boss. Joining us from Broadhead, Wisconsin, Devin Pitbull C. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 5'7" tall and weighed in at 145 pounds. He trains at Absolute Martial Arts and Fitness and is sponsored by Ruby's Pub and Grill, Wagner Investments, Hemp Kitty, West Central Tree Service, and EP True Chiropractic. Joining us from Des Moines, Iowa, Alex Coover.
Alex Coover flexing them karate makers as he gets ready to step in here.
Couple of mean mugs.
Yes.
Ready to step into the middle of the cage.
Here we go. Starting this one out here. Cooper going for a little leg kick there, missed it.
I like the neon trunks on black that Devin's wearing. Good stuff right there. Get the black light in the cage.
Right. That's the New Yorker in your chalk.
100%. That's 100%. Funny. I need some.
Big right here.
Cooper lands.
Nice leg kick, too, from Hoover. Hoover.
Call him Alex, don't call me Hoover Coover. I feel like that's a convoluted name.
Oh, right, left, right. Both these guys taking the time here.
Another left, right by Sykes. Ooh, another left right.
That one landed on the chin of Coover there with that right.
Coover didn't blink hardly at all.
No, though. He ate it.
Took that right, backed him up a bit.
Clash of heads there.
Ooh, big knee by Coover. I'll tell you what.
Beautiful. That one landed.
Devin just stared him down as he went up with it. Ooh, right left.
Nice counter there from Sykes.
Coover defended, though. He did well, threw the punches, and then covered up real well.
Throwing thunder and lightning over here.
Without a doubt. Bad intentions on all these strikes here.
You know what? He came in. It looked like for a second there, Devin came down a little awkward when he was trying to walk around. We'll keep an eye on his footwork.
Ooh, nice leg kick from Coover, blocked by Sykes, though. Still probably didn't feel good. Feints from Sykes, trying to get him guessing.
And he is. He's moving those hips. Making them think. At the same time, Coover is very active in and out.
Ooh, big right hand. These guys are eating
right
shots here.
By Sykes.
Slowed him down a little bit.
Coover got stung a little bit
on
that
one.
He hopped on his bicycle a little bit, right back in the cut there.
He's right back in it.
Coover walking him down.
Yeah, man.
Good
big
jab.
Straight left
stiff
there.
Stiff jab.
Another stiff left jab. Gets a leg kick, though.
Punch and counter punch here and counter strikes. attempt an uppercut there.
First takedown attempt.
Big dump. Big scoop.
Let's see where he goes from here. Sykes does the right thing, immediately wall walking.
Back to his feet here.
Ooh, big knee on the way up. Beautiful. Oh, uppercut though on the way out by Sykes. Man!
Beautiful transitional striking.
The barn burner.
It is.
Folks, this is a pro fight, so we got over 2 minutes to go in the first round.
Yeah, you can always tell when the guys show up that are getting paid. Things change a little bit.
Yeah. If it don't make dollars, it don't make sense. Both these guys very evenly matched. How's that poll looking, JB?
You got Devin Sykes at 55.81% and Alex Coover at 44. But right now, this fight's dead even to me.
You see the welt showing up on Sykes' left
body
leg
kick
there.
I like that. In and out. Oh, but Sykes coming back with a three-piece. Somebody get me some Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Oh, boy.
Hey, I got the biscuits and gravy, baby. I don't have the three-piece.
Nice double. Locked it up.
Awesome again.
Big slam.
And he came down on his arm first there.
Yeah, big power there. Brought him down hard.
Good way
to
dislocate your shoulder.
Got to be careful sticking that arm out there.
Cooper
looking to the side. Maybe going to try to trap that arm. Nope, steps over.
Roll through. Oh, wow. Got too high with his center of gravity and got rolled through.
Yes,
got to stay
did.
Extremely low. There should be no daylight between you when you go to that.
A minute left with Sykes on top. This has been a back and forth battle on the feet. We're at the ground right now. Let's see what happens.
An absolutely tough scrappers
here.
Oh,
big up kick right there. Man, good leg kick.
Sykes not giving him any room to breathe.
Not
there.
Just letting him up, giving him those thigh kicks right there in the top. He's got to watch that up kick, though, man. He looks like he wants to come down with a Henderson bomb. But, you know, you can take an Anderson Silva up kick.
25 seconds left here in round number one.
Nothing.
Nope, got blocked on the way down.
Yeah.
Cooper did a really good job. Ooh, good shot from Cooper from the bottom. I like that temple shot.
Well, he's cuffing his hand and hitting him on the ear. It's an eardrum thing.
Yeah, it's an open hand palm slap right there, a la Boss.
Pop somebody's eardrum with that.
Yeah, there you go.
Can we just call that the a la Boss from now on?
Okay.
I like that.
Matt Hume used to do that a lot.
You like that open hand strike?
Absolutely. Matt Hume used to cup the back of your neck as well. And then remove that hand just as the palm heel was clipping you in the back of the friggin' head.
Ouch.
That stuff would make you see your picture would jump around a little bit.
Well, I got a real question for you. Barn burner of a round, who are you giving it to?
You know, I'm leaning towards Coover. Very, very close, though. Could have gone either way, as you said.
Yeah. I mean, it's tough because what? Sykes is on top at the very end. Yeah, right. He reversed it around. But there was a lot of back and forth on the feet. And nobody.
Sykes throws everything he throws is literally for the fences.
Yes, it is.
A lot of incredible
There's
counters.
There's a straight that lands by Sykes and then a hook. That three-piece I was talking about.
Nobody
was that dump. We didn't get to see him take
Cooper
the
getting those two punishing takedowns could sway it a little bit his way, too.
Well, folks, if it ends up going to the judges, I guess we'll find out. But a lot of time left in this fight.
Yeah,
10
absolutely.
Minutes to go. Round two about to kick off. They look like they're both having fun in there. Not the mean mugs. Now it's the smile mugs. That's so weird.
Having a good time together.
Yes, they are.
Ooh, big uppercut.
Whoa, that
shook him.
That knocked him in the eye, too.
Going for that takedown again. Coover's doing what works for him. If it ain't broke, don't break it.
All that work.
Sykes back to his
Sykes
feet.
Right back up. Push off to some striking, maybe back in on the legs.
Ooh, good knee on the way out. My goodness.
These boys are banging.
I mean, Coover was uncomfortable from that uppercut. Devin Sykes trying to go back to that uppercut.
Sykes
right there.
Is hurting him with those uppercuts.
Yes, he is.
Coover missed it.
Shot.
Ooh, yeah, he opened him up, too.
Coover's leaking.
Sykes getting aggressive.
Ooh,
these boys are throwing each other. For every strike, there's a counter strike. These boys are not playing.
No, left
rocked
hand.
Rocked him.
Shook him.
Goes for the takedown. Smart move. Gets it. All right.
Coover got clipped behind the ear. That's where his balance went off.
Sykes again doing a good job. Walking up against the cage.
finding his balance. Hoover gets a nice beat, a nice body knee, man. That was good. Yes. That made him more.
Sykes is leaking now,
yes,
too.
Yes, he is. Oh, big right hand. Stunned him. That knee, Hoover's opening up. He's really hurt. His body's not there. His head's about gone.
It's
this
over.
Is gonna be it.
It's going to be
over. Hoover's going to finish this fight. He's really trying right now. Big knee to the
big
body.
Knee.
Sykes somehow surviving.
He's grabbing the leg.
Yes, here come the hammer fist. This is coming close. Sykes doesn't want to give it up.
True. 3.5 minutes left.
Not defending himself. Referee's looking at it.
He's looking at it. He's trying to drag that leg. If I'm Cooper, I want to create some distance.
Look at him throwing elbows. Look at this.
Oh, my
Sykes
goodness.
Sykes is as tough as they come. My goodness.
Sykes has
got to
move. Sykes has got to move.
It all started with that body shot. Oh, these elbows are brutal.
Look at Sykes.
What a fight.
Sykes trying to come back here.
Getting his head back together here.
The blood flowing from both fighters. As we have 3 minutes to go in the second round.
Sykes wants that Hulk Hogan rip his t-shirt in half moment.
Big knee to the face.
He is unloading.
Right hand.
Look at this.
Sykes taking some serious shots here.
He might gas himself.
Oh, shot behind the ear again. Another one.
Clubbing right hands. Sykes trying to just hold on right now. Lock those hands if he can.
Look at the neck.
He's got him locked. He might get a takedown.
Wow.
And he does.
Wow. And he dumps him down.
Buddy, look at the triangle coming.
He needs to do a lot of work from the top.
He's going to turn out of it possibly. It looks like he's trying to angle his body to turn out of it. He got out of it.
Sykes out of trouble.
Now he's in control.
Let's see if he can do something with it with 2 minutes left here in the second round.
He needs to. He's way behind on this round.
If you're going to go for triangles, you can't give up mount like that.
There he goes. Let's see if he can take advantage.
And remember, Hoover took a rough shot in the first minute. That uppercut rocked him, took another one. And right now, you got Sykes on top after taking some serious switch position.
These guys getting too high, center of gravity, and getting rolled through.
Both of these fighters have taken some serious shots here.
And now that's happened with both fighters. Looks good for the goose. It's good for the gander.
Yeah, got to keep your game tighter, bro. What a war, though.
Seriously. 1 minute, 30 seconds in this second round. Can't believe Sykes survived that barrage from Cooper.
Some short elbows,
arm
trying
bar,
to do the work.
Arm bar. Not there.
Ooh, punches from the bottom.
Sykes spinning, trying to go for a leg, but Cooper put an end to that.
And now Cooper on top to work.
Crazy, big elbow there.
Both guys expending huge amounts of calories.
Yeah, I'm anxious to see if they keep the same energy for this third round, if it makes it there.
Look at the fingers in the mouth there almost.
Fans on their feet all throughout the arena right now. Very exciting fight. Ooh, some big left hands making their way through.
Sykes raining down some blows. I'm sorry.
Oh, that elbow was big. Two big elbows.
30 seconds left.
Going for that leg and removing that arm from protection. Your head.
Opened him up.
I mean, he bounced his head right off that mat.
Yeah, like a Voight basketball.
Voight. I don't even know if that company's still around.
All right, we'll go with a Rawlings.
He's better.
Spalding.
Hey, I like the Voight. I didn't have a lot of money growing up. Sometimes you got to get those Velcro sneakers. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Or the Miska back in the day, the Dr. Dodgeball days. I used to give Miska tattoos all day.
And, you know, another tough round to score. I really think we could see a mixture. I mean, I think it's a Cooper round.
I think so.
Because he was just so dominant, but Sykes had his moments in that.
Yeah.
We don't know how the judges scored the first one. That one was razor thin. So with that being said, what are you telling both corners here, Pat?
I'm telling them they're down and they got to go for it. That's what I'm telling them. Period. Got to go for it. And if I'm Cooper's corner, I'm telling him we're going to get a takedown and we're gonna stay on top the entire time.
Absolutely.
Let's get out of here with less damage this time, right?
And watch that body weight, right? You don't want to posture up too much. You've been rolled.
Yep.
You know.
Stay low.
Sykes definitely looking like he's taking some damage, which he obviously has.
Watching that big overhand right there by Cooper and another knee. Oh, there's a...
Clubbed him.
That was that one behind the ear, dropped him.
And, you know, they are on vinyl, so you have to remember that the footing sometimes with all the sweat and everything else out there, you get clubbed like that, you can see his feet slip.
Yeah, I've noticed that too. Vinyl compared to canvas, it's just different as far as, like you said, your footing goes.
Well, you told me in the past that, you know, we used to tell your fighters, if you catch him and he's on one of the advertisements and you see the site has slipped, that's when you go forward.
Yes.
100%.
100%. And outdoor fights, which I've been in, in actual rain on vinyl, it's skating rink.
I don't even know that happened.
That's insane.
Hugging it out for the final round.
Devin Sykes' coach asking how bad do you want it. We'll see here in these final moments of this third round.
Starts with the uppercut, 1, 2, 3.
Out. He's coming out. Look at him getting after down. It.
And he needs to. Oh,
he needs that.
He's fired up.
I think he just answered his coach's question on how bad he wants it.
Yeah.
Looking to get the side control. Knee still on the belly from the bottom on Cougar. Still making it uncomfortable. Not able to get a lot of offense. Trying to get to the side. I'd love to see him try to trap that arm. It's coming a little low right now.
Got to get that knee out of his way. Get that shin bone out.
Got to stay busy so we don't see a stand-up here from the ref.
Now he's good. See if he works to mount, potentially.
Yeah, looking at that arm right now.
Love to see some of them knees you keep talking about, JB. Perfect position. His whole ribs are open right here.
Man, I'd love for him to try to drag that arm down and step over it, get some damage.
Guard recovery there. Cooper doing a good job getting back to neutral position. Armbar attempt.
Yep. Looking at it again. This time he might have it.
Pretty deep.
Got to extend on it.
Can he extend it? Sykes gets the legs loose. But his arm is still trapped
Climbing over. He's going to be good once he gets to the other side.
There it is.
Wow.
Nice scramble from Sykes.
Textbook. Trying to step over. Neither of these guys have any grit in them. My goodness. Devin Sykes going for it right now.
Absolutely no quit in Sykes. You kidding me?
Controlling the round right now. Burning the clock.
I mean, again, third round, tough fight. A lot of guys give that arm up.
He's burning the clock, but time's not really on his side because I think he's down, isn't he?
I mean, it's tough. That first round was so tough, man.
First round was very close.
Very, very close. We could be seeing a split decision here if this round keeps going this way. We don't know. And Cooper looks very uncomfortable, breathing heavy underneath.
Cooper's got to get an underhook with that left arm. He's digging in at least under the neck. Create some space to move.
Is there right now to the back now.
Cooper trying to get moving, but he needs that underhook. He's got to get the underhook.
Left hand from Sykes.
Arm triangle coming.
Looking for it. Can he step over?
He's got to stick his head to the mat. Once you get that going, you got to get your head to the mat. Cooper trying to get that guard back. Got Chief Blackhawk on his shin bone, looks like.
I saw that.
Am I correct?
I don't know if that's Blackhawk, but definitely a Native American. He's got that arm triangle set up all day. He's lifting that arm up. He needs to get his head under that left arm. There it is. Slipping it under there, trying to.
Arm's in the way, though.
Yeah.
Knee on the belly. By holding onto the head on bottom, Cooper's just allowing him to push him down.
Oh, and he's got the mount.
1 minute, 30 seconds here in this final round.
Underhook for Cooper in those positions would have made a huge difference. Could have escaped much easier. Look at him rolling, trying to roll through. Almost got him over.
Big shot. He's going to let him take his back.
He has a safe. He's
still got him locked in. He's got the
bottom
triangle, yes.
1 minute left, and 1 minute 15. Dangerous position
still
here.
Still leaning to the side a little bit, not fully on the back.
He's got the arm trap, so it's hard to stay up top. And he's got to get that. He's going to end up on bottom.
Yes, he is.
And he's trapping the arm on the bottom, trying to get far side wrist control.
Doesn't quite get there, but
there
he's
it is.
In the dominant Whoop. Position, and now he's on top. Boy, this is going to be a tough one to score.
Yeah.
Let's see how much damage Cooper can do from the top.
In these final moments, less than a minute left here.
Sykes had a lot of control right there, but how much damage did he do?
Yeah, very little.
You know, a couple of elbows changes the complexion of this fight in a big way. Cooper still on top.
Who wants it?
Exactly. 30 seconds.
His coach is screaming at him, last call, last call.
both of these fighters. Wow, just tough as the day is long.
Sykes on the bottom, takes a short elbow, not a lot on it.
Armbar.
Oh, looks for the armbar.
Slippery.
Slips out. Hoover, oh, ooh, big
right hand from the top.
Oh, here we go.
Another right hand by Hoover.
10 seconds to do it. 8, 7, 6. Down by Sykes. Man, this is going to be tough to score.
Big collision.
I do not want to be in the judges' seat.
Sykes wins the third round.
I liked it. Boy, oh boy. That was a battle for 15
bangers,
minutes.
Bangers,
that was great.
Bangers.
Very much a contender for fight of the night.
That was definitely contender for fight of the night right there.
Absolutely.
That was a scrap.
I would say that was fight of the night.
Yeah, so far.
I don't think contender. God.
We still got two left, so.
Do not count your chickens before the cow jumps over the moon. You know what I say.
Both fighters looking beat up, man. They put in some work tonight.
Everybody. Oh, good times, Mr. Miletich. We're watching some of the action here.
Both guys just literally putting it all out there.
Here's one of those dunks
Sykes
on the side.
Sykes coming back with his own takedown at the beginning of that round.
Look at that big right that landed from the top. But again, what happened? He gets right back up. He's ready to trade again. Cage Aggression crew in there cleaning up, doing a bang-up job.
Hell of a fight.
Hell of a fight.
Both guys well-trained.
Loved it. Technical battle everywhere. A little bit of a brawl.
Yeah.
A little bit of a brawl.
Mix of everything.
Yep. Fashionista, Pat, you've been over to the house.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Hey, you got some good hats.
Yes.
I think
yes.
I saw that pedophile hunter one last week.
I had a large collection, actually, of military and law enforcement hats from all the years. Those are my favorites.
Good stuff.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to our judges' scorecard for our decision. Our judges scored this contest 29-28, Coover. 29-28, Sykes. And 29-28, declaring your winner by split decision, Devin Pitbull C.
That was a tight one, man. Did not want any of the judges on that decision.
Second split of the night.
Come on over, Devin. Hey, you know, there shouldn't be one disappointed person in the building after the action that we just saw here. Hey, tell us what's going through your mind after such a tough win like that, Devin.
Oh, you know what? First of all, that man is a beast. I mean, I hit him with a bunch of good shots, and, you know, he stayed on his feet. I hurt him a few times and didn't take advantage of it. It is what it is. I'm not upset with the fight. I pushed through. I had a little adversity there in the second. I know the ref, he wanted to stop that, but he gave me a chance, you know, to fight through, and I appreciate that. All in all, I worked real hard for that, and I'm glad to be back in the win column, especially off a fight like that.
Well, we're definitely glad to have you back. I know you were looking forward to getting into the win column here at Caged Aggression. Hey, tell us, what's around the corner? You got anything planned?
You know what? I hope to get in the cage right away. Mike. Let me get a title shot on this next card, baby. Let's go. But no, I'm ready to get right back in there. I'll get back in next week, and if I have to, the way the face looks or not, I'm ready to run it real. It doesn't matter.
Well, we all believe that. Hey, look, there's a few people over here that are happy to get that win with you. Hey, talk to them real quick before I let you get to it.
Hey, I want to thank all of you. You all show up with me. We're from 2.5 hours away. Personally, I want to thank my mom, my brother Aaron, especially them too. You know, they're my lifeline. I could not be here without them. And I think that my mom made all them shiny shirts. You see them? My mom and her friend. You know, they did an awesome job on that. Second of all, I want to thank everyone at home. Everyone at home that I know is at Tracy's Bar. Congratulations, Tracy. She just bought that bar. I appreciate you for throwing the watch party for me tonight. And I love you all, and I appreciate you all. And I want to let you know that I'm back in a win column, and I'm staying in it.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it one more time loud for your winner tonight, Devin Pitbull Feast.
Wow, what an incredible fight as we move into the co-main event of the evening. Nico Jefferson and Michael Shipp. Like I mentioned in the intro, this fight was originally scheduled in October, but Michael Shipp had to pull out due to injury. So here we are, getting ready to make it happen right here.
This was my pick for fight of the night. I don't know how they're going to top the last one, but this was my original pick for fight of the
night.
Yeah,
it looks like it's going to be the last one. But then again, we got two more to go. There's been some really good scraps.
Oh,
we got
one more.
Scraps.
Oh, yeah. Two more, including this one.
Yes, the heavyweight scrap was a great scrap, but hands down, that was fight of the night so far. Let's see if Nico Jefferson and Michael Shipp can make it happen.
Well, and that last fight we saw just encapsulates this whole weekend, man. The will to win, the tenacity, never say die, never quit. As Nico Jefferson makes his way to the cage out of Battle Horse, Kankakee, Illinois. He was just interested in the workouts. The guys I trained with talked him into 40-plus fights later. Talked him into getting into it, but 40-plus fights later, he's still in it. He had no plans on completing kind of an accidental MMA career. He's excited about this matchup. I know he brings it every time he fights, and so do I. If he can get his hands on you, he can finish the fight, he says. He also does kickboxing. Overall, he has 20 KOs and TKO victories between the two sports. He's looking to finish every time.
Yeah, I've seen Nico fight at least 10 times. Dude, you could call him to fight anybody. He's one of those guys. And so is Michael Shipp. Both these guys are anytime, anywhere, anyone. So it's going to be a really great fight.
And we're expecting a striking matchup. These guys love to kickbox. Where do you think it's going first? Who do you think is going to strike first?
Nico's probably got the athleticism edge. He's going to have really explosive striking. He's going to want to keep it on the feet. I mean, he had that, like, two-minute war with Brant Cooper. That was, like, one of the best 2 minutes you'll ever see in MMA. He's going to go for the kill right off the bat. And Michael Shipp, just as dangerous. Michael Shipp probably has the advantage on the ground, but I think it's going to be a slugfest on the feet. And it could get finished on the feet real fast by Nico. On the ground, it's going to be over real quick with Michael Shipp.
So no three-round war. We're not going to see a repeat of the last one. You think someone's lights are going out?
I think someone's getting a sick finish here. But it'll be interesting to see because we haven't seen Battleship in a while. You know, he's coming off a long layoff. We'll see what version of him shows up. Because,
exactly.
You know, he was 3-0, you know, and he had a couple losses in a row. We'll see if he reinvented himself.
Now, how do you deal with that as a fighter? Especially, you know, one loss is tough enough, obviously. You want to learn from that. But you get two in a row, it can be a career changer, can it?
Yeah, man. In this sport, I mean, you got to be, you know, everybody wants to be a good hammer, but you got to be a good nail, too, you know? You got to learn how to build yourself back up. But here comes Battleship, man. He's one of the most exciting guys here.
Looking forward to him back in the cage. Michael Battleship out of Midwest Martial Arts Group at Nyquist Roundhouse, Henry, Illinois. Currently resides in Milan. He was searching, how he got into the game, he was searching through the channels one day and landed on UFC Unleashed and one of Chuck and Tito's fights and fell in love at first sight. Found the opportunity to do it years later, the rest is history. He recognized the fact that Nico is a great kickboxer. He is excited for a hell of a stand-up fight. Should it go to the ground, he says, he will not be worried. Feels that his grappling is going to be a difference maker. He feels great on the ground. Feels his stand-up is always improving. Looks up to Tyson Fury and Max Holloway. He's only been finished once in his MMA career at caged aggression Sturgis. He fought two rounds with a broken arm and lost a split decision. So there is no punk in Michael Battleship as he comes out with the entourage.
Look at Jordan Towers. He comes out with everybody, man. He's happy to be here.
He's the best, man. We love Jordan Towers here.
He's the best hype man for sure.
And calling this fight with us, ladies and gentlemen, the human highlight reel once again stepping in on the stick. Like we we mentioned, Brandon Jenkins, that is, has a fight coming up soon in April for the UFC. Obviously, wish you luck, brother.
Thank you so much. Yeah, I owe everything to Cage Aggression, man. You win this belt, you know, doors open up for you. So I always tell the younger guys, man, get the Cage Aggression, work your way through the ranks. You get that belt, you get a lot of eyes on you, and big things happen for you.
Well, it's an incredible proving ground. Like you said, you get that belt and doors open up. We've seen it happen many times, yourself included. And, you know, Pat, the promotion's grown by leaps and bounds, man. It is a worldwide promotion right now. Once we got that first global pay-per-view by, the game done changed around here at Cage Aggression. Yep. And like I said, they're bringing nothing but elite talent, veterans to the LFA, Bellator, UFC. This is a tremendous proving ground and can absolutely change careers.
And absolutely, it's also a great, great place for some of the younger fighters like we've seen tonight, again, Mills, Blackberry, to get their start, man. And it's just awesome to watch them grow. We got Michael Schiff right now coming in, actually not as the favorite, but the underdog, 37.5% on the polls. If you think that's the wrong way to go, if you're in more of agreement with Brandon Jenkins than Nico Jefferson coming out with the fire, make sure to hit those polls.
I just think people haven't seen Michael Schiff in a while. Nico's been a little more active. We'll see what Michael Schiff brings to the table. It's been a while since we've seen him.
Well, in between an absence and taking a couple L's, like you said, you made a great point. Which fight, which version of Michael Schiff is going to show
up?
Yeah,
he took a huge, when he was 3-0, he took a huge step up the competition. Like, he fought former title challenger Aaron Mitchell, and he fought Juan Roman, who's a nasty striker, one of the best in Iowa. So, you know, he took a step up. Maybe it was a little too soon for him, but we're going to see which version of him shows up today.
You are correct, sir. Here we go.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our co-main event of the evening. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the Caged Aggression Professional Lightweight Division, powered by La Quinta Inns and Suites. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 156 pounds. He trains at Battle Horse MMA and is sponsored by Garden of Prayer Youth Center, Triple J's Rolling Video Games, Fly Above It Clothing, Apply Pressure Clothing, Shake the Fear Clothing, Marge Denage Clothing, and A Cloud of Smoke Podcast. Joining us from Champaign, Illinois, Nico Boom Jefferson. And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6 feet tall and weighed in at 154 pounds. He trains at Summit Training Center and MMAG and is sponsored by Hearth Roofing and Construction, River Valley Motors, Sisler's Dairy Products, Luscious Painting and Supply, and Say Uncle Photography. Joining us from Milan, Illinois, Michael Battle Schiff.
And you can't get much better of a nickname than Battleship,
right?
Yeah. I love it.
The Battle and Nico are about ready to do it right here in our co-main event of the evening.
Look for a fast start from Nico. He likes to take the center and push you right back. He wants you behind that red line.
And Chip almost looks like another human being from when I interviewed him at the weigh-ins, man. He's filled out so much. You know, that's another big part of the game. Being able to control that weight cut with your camp. So many factors going into this.
Chip's definitely got the length on him.
Ooh, big spin, that small leg kick, very quick.
Nico's got some powerful kicks. He's got tons of kickboxing experience, pro kickboxing.
Yeah, it seems to be his bread and butter there. Just see if he, see how this plays out here in the opening round here.
Being very patient, trying to find the distance. Chip, the longer fighter, steps in. Overhand right, just misses. Front kick from Chip.
Chip's chin's getting a little high. He needs to tuck his chin.
I can't agree more, man. That is a very, very high chin. Ooh, big overhand right, that chin was high.
He just jumped on it. Nico just took advantage of that.
Chip needs to tangle him up and drag him to the ground.
Jefferson backing up to the cage, small leg kick. Back to
definitely
the center.
Finding a home with those leg kicks.
Leg kick return from Schiff, goes to the body. Lower leg kick from Jefferson. Jefferson looking really calm in there.
Very crisp, too.
Ooh, big overhand right, lands left. Schiff trades back.
Nico with some bad intentions on them strikes.
Another that overhand right is coming through. I'd like to see a setup on it.
I can't tell if Chip is hurt or if it's just how he moves, you know?
With that spin?
Yes. Well, he was spinning early, right?
Oh, nice takedown. Got the old school big brother bulldog headlock going.
They're in Chip's world now. He's trying to isolate that arm and go for an Americana with his legs.
Jefferson grabbing that wrist, doing a good job trying to control it right there, but Chip across on the other arm, pulling it down.
Trying to isolate it there.
Trying to get the Dagestani handcuffs from the back. Nico's working his way back
some
up.
Some shots right there.
Trying to get his back here.
He's got one hook in as he tries to get his back.
Plenty of time left here in this first round.
Under the chin, let's see. Nope, not quite there. Fighting the hands.
Tough position up against the cage here to do any flattening out or anything.
But certainly looking for that neck, though, right now.
Chip's got some good submission.
He's looking at him right there. Something happened.
Just making sure he didn't
poked him somewhere in the eye, maybe.
Finger in the eye.
It was a finger in the eye as he went for it.
Is this an injury timeout?
Yes, it's just an injury timeout. Okay. It's not the end of the fight. It was completely accidental. He was trying to slip that choke in. And while he did it, you know, Bruce, to his credit, saw it immediately.
Well, this is good for Nico Jefferson. The fight's going to start back on his feet.
As long as his eye does recover. Have you ever been in that situation? I mean, everybody talks about the gloves and training. What's that eye poke like?
I'll tell you what. When I fought Aaron Mitchell here for the belt, he punched me in the eyeball. And my eyeball, it was like stuck looking down for a second.
Ooh.
Yeah, it was weird. It was like I was stuck looking at my right foot. So I like almost went blind in my right eye for a good like 3 minutes in the third round. It was terrifying.
Here it is right here. You look at it. He just kind of clamped down and he's trying to grab in. I'm sure it was terrifying, especially when you're in the middle of, I don't know, a fist fight.
Well, and it looks like he was ready to lean back and get him flattened out as he had that rear naked going.
Yeah, eyes are no joke, man. I literally thought my eyeball was ruptured. It's terrifying. All the horrible thoughts that go in your head. You're
God.
Yeah.
He said eyes are no joke.
Yeah, no, they are not.
Putting it lightly.
And they're looking at it right now. The doctor's in there. He's going to have 5 minutes to recover. We're going to see where this is going. The doctor's looking. It's still pretty closed right now.
Scratch cornea or something.
We would hate to see this be the way the fight ends. But again, I mean, that you don't have much control over it. Either you recover or you don't. Either you're Brandon Jenkins looking down at your foot for 3 minutes, not even sure what's going on, grinding it out, or you're not.
Again,
that wasn't really a slip. I mean, that's a punch sometimes that gets through the eye socket.
Yeah, he punched me straight in the eyeball. It was terrible. You know, and to be honest, a lot of these guys don't get hit straight in the eyeball. I've probably been hit straight in the eyeball in 20-something fights, probably like 5 times. Like, the glove just doesn't fit in there, you know?
Yeah, so, most of the time, right? You have an eyebrow for a reason.
Yeah.
Nico having a tough time keeping that eye open.
Doctor taking a close look at it. And this is the last way that Nico Jefferson
that
wanted
would
this fight to end.
Just be tragic.
Especially when things are going good for him on the feet, you know? And if they restart, they're going to be back on the feet anyway, so. Maybe just to take the full 5 minutes and restart.
Bruce over there making sure. He's telling him, keep his hands clear of the eyeballs.
Doctor's taking a close look, still talking to him. Remember, the fighter's safety is of the utmost importance.
Without
we don't want him getting in there, not being able to see.
Yeah, especially fighting. You know, you can't see the shots coming. That's definitely dangerous.
I mean, no thank you. You know, this isn't a karate movie, folks. There is no zen. You're going to want to have your hands up at all times. You're going to be able to see. It's tough. He's still looking. Certainly not giving up.
Yeah, this is what we were talking about, blood sport last night. Chung Lee threw the powder in Van Damme's eyes, and he still kept fighting, even though he was blind.
Yep, that's called Hollyweird.
Yes.
That's not reality.
Kumite.
Still deserves a remake. Let's do it.
Like I told you, you got something in the works, baby.
It's opening up a little bit, but it's still very, very closed.
Who's keeping an eye on that 5-minute timer?
It's not looking promising right here, folks. I got to tell you. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but right now, I don't know if this fight's going to continue.
He's finally getting it open, but it's not staying open.
Looks like he's going to go for it. Let's see what we got. Awesome.
No punk in Nico Jefferson. He's ready to go.
Hope the eyes are right, man.
Yeah.
You want to be able to see with Michael Shipp's got some awkward movement, some awkward striking. You know, you want to have that eye open.
Referee Bruce Allen, he has 5 minutes, but can't be
five left right now.
His corner's telling him if you can't do it, don't do it.
Doctor's going to take a real good look at that eye. He's probably going to make the decision right now. Man, that is tough.
Doctor asked him if he can open it. Doesn't sound like he can open it.
Yeah, Nico Jefferson. Yeah, no quit. And
tough one. Michael Battleship not cool with that decision. But so, like you said, JB, fighter's safety, fighter's health is the utmost importance.
You know, either we have a DQ or a no contest here.
That'd be a no contest.
I would hope it's a no contest. You know, it was completely inadvertent going for that choke.
That was unfortunate.
Yeah, it's very disappointing for the co-main event of the evening, but
these guys were going at it too, man.
I wouldn't blink for the main, I'll tell you that.
No pun intended.
Not with the big boys.
No. Not with Mota and those big, big hands. And Cedric Savage says, no, not me. I'm coming with the Thunder myself.
And these guys were just getting started too, man.
Hopefully they'll rebook it October. Is that when the next one is? October?
I'm not sure. I have not heard anything about another card. Probably
if
something
I had
this
my
summer.
Way, we'd be doing it next week,
you know?
My good one. Keep it going.
Next
I
month.
Kid a little bit because, you know, it takes a lot.
Tell him, bring back the Challenger Series, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Let's stay busy this summer, El Jefe. Man, I mean, it's tough anyway for a co-main event to end like this, but these guys having to have it postponed for a year, Michael Battleship getting back into the groove of things, so disappointing on so many levels.
I'm glad he's active again, though.
Yeah, for sure.
I
don't want to be messing with, like, a scratch corny or, you know.
Nope. Looks like they're going to Vargas right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Bruce Allen, called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 20 seconds into round one, resulting in a no contest due to an accidental finger to the eye.
I mean, it happens, man. This isn't ballet. This isn't square dancing.
A bit disappointing, but what can you do?
Very disappointing.
On to the main event.
Yeah, disappointing is an understatement. Disappointing is not, I mean, it's terrible, man. But we move on to the main event, the triple exclamation points for the triple threat, not, you know, the triple night weekend. We've been doing it, man, all three nights, and it culminates tonight, right now, with Gabriel Mota and Cedric Savage, our main event of the evening, and we bring to a close an incredible weekend of mixed martial arts action. Cage Aggression 33, the trifecta, is about to be in the history books. We got to get through this main event first. What's that poll looking like, JB?
We got Gabriel Mota as the slight, and I mean slight, favorite at 52% and change. Cedric Savage at 47%. And I got to tell you, both fighters extremely confident. We've seen Mota in this cage before doing damage, knocking people out. He's coming off a big knockout. But Cedric Savage did not seem intimidated. And you look at this gentleman coming down the cage. This is really the epitome of I'm not intimidated.
Yeah,
so sparks are going to fly, fists are going to flow, and faces are getting touched with the heavy.
As Gabriel Manas de Piedra Botas makes his way into the cage, Chicago fight team, Hammond, Indiana. He needed a career after college wrestling. That's how he got into the game. He said he's excited for this war. Thinks his strengths are his boxing and his wrestling. Looks up to Roberto Duran.
Oh, I love Roberto Duran.
Mike Tyson, Vitor Belfort, Hector Lombard. And again, this is one he had to adapt to at the last minute because this was not his original opponent. His original opponent was Darian Abbey, and he had to obviously adjust for this new opponent.
Well, and the fact that he said he followed and really looked up to Roberto Duran. All right, I already like him because of that.
Absolutely. You know, it's funny because not even my generation is probably the tail end of respect for Roberto Duran, but during your generation, I mean, some of those wars.
Go back and look at
Sugar Ray Leonard?
Literally, well, when Roberto Duran was young, Wilfred Benitez era, all that sort of stuff, when literally the films are in black and white, some of them. Dude, you talk about straight killers. Like, Duran was a straight killer when he was in, like, shape and in his prime. Deadly.
It's kind of unfortunate that, I mean, his career was very accomplished, but...
Legend in my mind, bro.
Well, no, he is, but
I'll tell you what.
Most people know him from the No Mas and, you know, getting
and
knocked out by Thomas Hearns.
Look, that's all ESPN stuff now.
Yeah,
when
yeah.
I was a kid and I was strolling through the channels and it was Channel 2 with some Wide World of Sports, boxing on Channel 9 or 11. I saw Roberto Duran, and, you know, this is way before the internet for all you youngins, you millennials watching these things. I wanted to see how it was going down. And yeah. I never disappointed. That guy never disappointed.
Duran was terrifying.
He really was, man. Cedric Savage making his way to the cage, fighting out of Vanderlei MMA and BJJ. Virginia Beach fighting out of Milwaukee. He needed a new hobby. So he found MMA. Good matchup, he says. Two men who are game ready, feel that his BJJ is going to be the difference maker. Looks up to Herschel Walker and Damian Maya. Herschel Walker had a little bit of a short stint in MMA.
Yes, he did.
Looked impressive, still impressive. The guy's almost 60, and he looks like he's 30.
Well, I talked to him one time after a Strikeforce show, and I asked him, I go, do you use Just For Men? His wife was standing with him. We were backstage. His hair, there's not a single gray anywhere on that man's head, and he's 50-something at the time, and he looks like he's 30. And I go, do you use Just For Men? He looked at me and he goes, what's Just For Men? And I go, no, he was totally serious. He'd never heard of it. And I go, you're kidding, right? And his wife goes, he has no clue. He has no clue what Just For Men. He doesn't use any of that stuff.
And, you know, he's
I go,
just,
this guy is a freak.
And he is a freak. I mean, he never was into free weights. He was all about,
pull-ups,
you know,
push-ups,
yeah,
squats.
Exactly. Still doing 1,000 sit-ups a day.
Yeah, he was doing 1,000 pull-ups, 1,000 push-ups, 1,000 squats a day.
Cedric Savage making his way into the cage as these boys are about ready to set it off in our main event of the evening.
Ladies and gentlemen, fight fans live in attendance at the River Center and everyone else streaming live on pay-per-view around the world, this is our main event of the evening. Scheduled for five-minute rounds for the Caged Aggression Professional Light Heavyweight Championship. Powered by 7G Distributing Bud Light. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He stands 5'9" tall and weighed in at 204 pounds. He trains at the Chicago Fight Team and 219 Cartel Fight Team and is sponsored by Absolute Nutrition, New Image Barbershop, Mexican American Leadership Association, and Carriers Incorporated. Joining us from Hammond, Indiana, Gabriel Hands of Stone Malta! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner. He stands 6'1" tall and weighed in at 204 pounds. He trains at Vanderlei Jiu-Jitsu and MMA and is sponsored by Dream Sports Management and Dope Desserts. Joining us from Kenosha, Wisconsin, Cedric Big Dog Savage!
I am excited for this one. They step to the middle of the cage. Here
gentlemen,
we go.
We went over the rules and expectations in the back. You guys want to touch them up? Touch them up. Let's have some fun.
Let's have some fun. Make
fun
this happen,
indeed.
Captain.
Big boy's about ready to unload.
Yes, sir.
If fun is taking a quick 30-second nap at about 11 p.m. in the Midwest, that's my prediction one way or the other. And they step in there, and the hands are about to throw.
Oh,
right out of the gates.
Yeah, yes. Wasting time.
No, sir. Savage pressing him up against the cage.
Ooh,
wow.
Nice short right.
Explosive.
Very much so.
Switch position there. Mota has
Mota with the uppercut on the inside. Elbow on the inside. And Cedric Savage pushes him up against the cage, looking to dump him, looking to pick him up.
We're going for a scoop right here.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mota's got a lot of weight on the
he's
lower
trying to
half.
Pull, he's trying to pull an oak tree out of the ground right now.
Yeah,
right.
Exactly.
He's got it.
He did.
Nice
he
job. Good angle on that takedown by Savage.
Very
nice
good.
Pass.
Full mount.
Straight
four
to
and
the
a half
mount.
Minutes. That's a lot of time right now.
Let's see if he can take advantage of it.
Key lock attempt
ooh,
here.
Ooh, fresh and strong. Let's see if he can do it.
Wow, this is an impressive performance.
Missed with the elbow. Nice
yeah,
escape there.
Mota out, looks for the neck. Not quite there. Back to their feet.
This is a bad spot for Savage,
man. I'm telling you right now, he doesn't want to let Mota get the distance and then just come over with an overhand right.
Mota, good reaction.
Takedown again from
just
Savage.
Back in.
Follow up by Savage. Good job. Half guard.
Get that head free there.
Steps right over again.
Pull him out.
So now this is where Mota, he shouldn't have let go of the head. He could have tried to bump him over and take him over the right side.
Looks like he might give up the back.
Oh, no.
Awkward spot for his arm right there. Back to flatten him out. If you're Savage's corner, what are you telling him to do? Elbows like that?
Take a deep breath. He's controlling the wrist there. He's doing a good job. Arm triangle.
Oh,
coming. Well,
that's good. That's
deep. He got his perfect position.
That's going to tap.
It's over, ladies and gentlemen. The opening seconds of the very first round. Curtis Savage with a dominant performance and a ridiculous arm triangle submission on a very tough Gabriel Mota.
You know, Cedric Savage was really, really impressive in there, man. He went right in there to fight. Took no moments, crowded space, didn't let Mota get off the big shots. Really celebrate. He's celebrating a la Jordan Trower style.
Hey, he said that BJJ was going to be the difference maker.
Savage was the replacement. Had nothing to lose. Came back up.
There you go. That's true. Big W. Both these fighters showing respect.
Absolutely.
That's it. That's all you, bro.
What a tremendous culmination to this incredible weekend.
And Savage tell him, listen, I know you could have punched me in the face. You got the big hammers, brother. Big celebration.
Cedric Savage with an impressive first round victory.
You know, what a great way to end the trifecta. Three nights of brutal fights. A lot of technical stuff tonight. A lot of great fights. You know, fight of the night, in my opinion, still Devin Seitz, Alex Coover.
Yeah,
that definitely
is the winner on that one.
100%.
But here we go to Jason Vargas to make it official. Cedric Savage, first round submission. And there it is right here, steps over really quick. Mota knew he was in trouble almost immediately.
Savage is hitting the club early tonight. He's in the ring dancing, in the cage rather.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Josh Stewart, has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 48 seconds into round one, declaring your winner by submission due to arm triangle and new caged aggression professional light heavyweight champion, Cedric Big Dog Savage.
Grats picked up a little, picked up some gold.
You're too close to her. You know what I'm saying?
I thought we were going to fight.
Shit. You were. You hit me.
Hey, come on over here, Cedric. All right, champ, welcome to the center of the cage, man. Congratulations on the new piece of hardware. Hey, talk to us how it feels coming out in your caged aggression debut and walking away with the belt.
My daughter's so happy. I'm on top of the world right now. This is God blessed right here. I've been working so damn hard. Striking on the ground, wherever the fuck it is, man, I'm good, whatever. My opponent's bad somewhere, I'm fucking great there. Shit. My opponent's fucking bad at jiu-jitsu, I'm fucking king of that shit. Fucking bad at, my opponent bad at striking, I'm gonna be king of that shit. I am a fighter, I grow, I evolve. I'm never the same fighter, baby. Wearing the late jiu-jitsu, Joe Nichols striking, hey, what's up? I'm back here, baby.
Well, we're definitely looking forward to that. But before we let you go, anyone you want to mention, anything you want to mention before we let you get to it?
I want to thank my number one sponsor, my wife. She out there. Thank my manager, Pete, David Atkins, Coach Joe, everybody, bro. Team Wendley. We're here. I came out dull, though, bro. I mean, no sponsors. Hey, we came to work.
Well, look, we're definitely looking forward to seeing what comes next. Hopefully we get a defense or two of that thing. But hey, until then, enjoy the moment. Enjoy the rest of the weekend. And let's hear it one more time, ladies and gentlemen, for your new caged aggression professional light heavyweight champion, Cedric Big Dog Savage.
What an absolute incredible culmination to an incredible weekend, boys. We have done it once again. Mike Goodwin, congratulations. You've done made history again, son. Wow. this second half of this season. The whole weekend was crazy, but we just saw some absolutely incredible fights. Joey Reyes picking up an incredible submission in the second round against a tough Michael Boylan.
Yeah, and that was a good back and forth battle a little bit there, you know.
It really was.
Very technical, great fight.
Yes.
Honestly, the second half of the card was just so impressive.
Yeah.
Unfortunate the co-main ended the way it did, but a very, very quick and technical submission in the main event.
Without a doubt. I mean, I thought those guys were going to bang a little bit more, but I think Cedric's move, which is doing what he did. He said the BJJ was going to be the difference maker, and it definitely was, because he did not want to see those hands from Mota, as we've seen him put people to sleep quickly.
I wanted to talk about Quinn Murphy and
Dalton Armstrong
a little bit. Quinn Murphy coming out with a big win there. Great performance on his part.
Another really big back-and-forth fight. You know, that was another really gritty one on the second half of the card. You know, Thomas Blackerby showing that, you know, he's a rising star in the kickboxing community. And then Devin Seitz, Alex Coover, Fight of the Night.
Fight of the Night. Back-and-forth battle, both of those guys. I leaned a little towards Coover in that matchup, but Seitz, look, it was close. You can't let it go to the judges. Either way, both guys very well trained, great endurance, got after it, right?
You definitely did not envy the judges in that position. And again, our co-main event, you know, was postponed for a year. Nico Jefferson against Michael Shipp, an accidental eye poke. Who knows how severe it is, scratch cornea, whatever it is. But Nico could not continue, which resulted in a no contest. And then again, as we just spoke on, you know, our new light cage professional, Cage Gresham, light heavyweight champion Cedric Savage, with a very, very impressive stoppage of a very tough Gabriel Mota. Again, gentlemen, it's been
an honor working with both of you.
It's been a pleasure, as always. Thanks to the whole Cage Aggression crew. I can't say it enough for so much time you guys put into making this weekend happen. Until next time, and there will always be a next time, because Cage Aggression is going nowhere. Much love, you guys. Again, I know you guys got so many choices on a weekend to hang out and do other things. We are so appreciative of you guys stepping in here and checking us out at cageaggression.tv. Until next time, peace and all that love.